And meanwhile, a federal judge ordered Arkansas to temporarily reinstate its Medicaid contract with Planned Parenthood after the state blocked funding over concerns about those secretly recorded videos. U.S. District Judge Christine Baker granted Planned Parenthood's request to block for 14 days the state from denying funding to the organization. Republican Governor Asa Hutchinson last month announced he was terminating the contract. The Obama administration is planning direct talks between Russian and American military officials soon over Russia's military buildup in Syria.
Most military talks with Moscow were suspended after Russia annexed the Crimea region of Ukraine. But Secretary of State John Kerry says President Obama believes military-to-military discussions with Russia are an important next step as the U.S. and its allies seek to resolve a worsening Syria crisis.
White House correspondent Greg Clugston. On Wall Street, the Dow down by 290 points to 16,385. The NASDAQ dropped 67. The S&P lower by 32. Oil down 222 to $44.68 a barrel. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Got a lot on your to-do list? Now, during Kubota's Power to Do Great Things sales event, get a great deal on an L3301 or 3901 tractor with a live continuous running rear PTO. Now get financing as low as 0% APR for up to 5 years, and great customer instant rebates when you buy a new L3301 or 3901 and two implements. Now through September 30th, 2015. Call toll-free 1-888-465-8268 for details about cost and terms. For more information or to find a participating dealer, visit Kubota.com.
We gave Tom 12 seconds to give 6 reasons why he opened a Mathnasium Learning Center franchise.
Okay. Great income potential. Doing good for kids. Doing what I love. Making math make sense to kids. 500 centers open already. 1 every 3 days. Mathnasium taught me the business. Helps me. Supports me.
Time's up. Pretty good. For franchise information, visit Mathnasium.com or take the first step right now. Call 855-361-MATH. That's 855-361-6284.
Two upper Midwest states, Wisconsin and Minnesota, are opening their doors and arms to people who have dementia and their loved ones. In Watertown, Wisconsin, Shirley Streisick sometimes forgets that she met somebody 2 hours prior or that she is no longer a nurse. So the 90-year-old is living in a nursing home in Watertown. Streisick, who has a form of Alzheimer's, says she appreciates the efforts to make her life easier.
Everybody was very pleasant. And I never heard anybody say, well, that's a stupid thing, or, you know, or criticize you.
Estate planning attorney Tom Levy says he's attended a recent training session on how to deal with people who have dementia.
I'm interested in helping them, keeping them independent, and at the same time ensuring that what they are interested in is actually going to be fulfilled.
News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. It is National Prisoners of War Mission in Action Recognition Day, and there were ceremonies at the Pentagon honoring that this morning. Defense Secretary Ash Carter told people assembled there that military personnel can be assured the effort to find and identify POWs and MIAs will continue.
Every soldier, sailor, airman, marine, and Coast Guardsman should know that I will do everything we can to bring them back to their families.
A Department of Defense official who helped debrief Bo Bergdahl after the Army sergeant was recovered in a prisoner exchange for 5 Taliban commanders by the Obama administration says Bergdahl was subjected to horrific abuse during his 5 years in captivity. Terrence Russell testified today at a hearing to determine if Bergdahl will face a court-martial. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period, with packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Why would you go anywhere else? KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free water purification kit for a limited time with any body armor package. Go to KDArmor.com. That's EATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Free Talk Live.
This is Free Talk Live, and of course, you can bring up whatever you want. That is the point of the radio show. That's why we call it Free Talk Live. We'll give you the toll-free numbers and the Skype here in a moment. Welcome to the show. I'm Ian.
And I'm Cantwell.
Christopher Cantwell is here from ChristopherCantwell.com. We'll talk more about that in a moment. There's what I consider to be breaking news out of New Hampshire right now, which happens to be where we are. We're here in the Keene area, which is a ways away from the seacoast of New Hampshire, where civil disobedience has spread to the seacoast. And of course, Keene, for those of you who've been longtime listeners of the show, you know that Keene is well known in sort of an infamous way, for some people at least, for civil disobedience. We had the 420 celebrations happening here back in 2009 that went on for a number of years. Of course, those, you know, still continue at the State House on a yearly basis to this day. And there was that. And then several other instances. Our friend Derek J. Freeman, of course, arrested 5 times in a 1-year time frame for various acts of civil disobedience and non-cooperation.
Victimless crime spree.
Yes. So, I mean, those are some of the things that are more noteworthy that have certainly resulted in activists being arrested for things that don't involve any kind of victim. Nobody claiming that they were harmed in the process. Although in the case of the Uber drivers on the seacoast, the taxi cab companies are certainly claiming that they are being victimized. And I want to talk about that coming up here. But first, let's go right into your calls and thoughts. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Jack wants to start us out here tonight, listening in Wisconsin to LRN.FM. Hello, Jack.
Hey, Ian. Thanks for taking my call.
Sure, that's what we do.
I'm calling about the student Ahmed Mohammed that reportedly created a clock and was arrested because some people thought it was a bomb just a few days ago.
Yeah, specifically it was his English teacher who thought it could be a bomb. So she, I think, snitched him out to the administration, who ultimately called the police, and he was arrested.
Yeah. So I'm starting to think that Ahmed didn't make the clock at all. It looks like he simply took the clock out of its plastic casing and placed it in a briefcase. So from what I've read and watched, it's pretty obvious that the circuitry is off, the transformer is AC, which is unrealistic for something like that. The circuit board is manufactured, the ribbon cables look very similar to manufactured products. So to me, I'm starting to think that this was designed to look like a device that would be intentionally suspicious, something like the Balloon Boy hoax back of like 2009.
I know what you're talking about there, Jack, and I've actually got I brought with me a story where somebody was making the same exact case. If you look at this thing, and I had mentioned this on Radical Agenda last night, just that the thing looked odd, right? If you put you're like, I'm going to build a clock, and I'm going to go put it in this little briefcase, and then my understanding of it as well was there was like wire sticking out of the thing, right? Like if you're trying to make a clock and you're going to put it in a box, like,
did you see it? I saw the picture of it.
Yeah. And if you look at
Closed in the case.
The picture that I see is after the box is opened up, however.
Yeah, and but I didn't see wires sticking out of it or anything like that. It looked like it was all self-contained to me.
Well, the picture that I'm looking at is of the thing opened up.
Yeah,
and
that's
what I thought. I recalled being told that there were wires sticking out of the thing. If that's correct, and I might be incorrect about it,
yeah.
But if that's correct, then that is obviously a suspicious thing that serves no legitimate purpose, right? Like if you're trying to build a clock inside of a container, there's no reason for there to be wires out of it. Now, I might be wrong about that. But if you're looking at this thing... The thing that Jack is bringing up, this is not something that the guy built, all right? Ahmed did not put this thing together with a soldering iron. He took a clock apart and then put it into this box and just sort of, I guess, cut out a piece of the box so that the LCD would be sticking through, or whatever the display of the clock was. And that's not a kid who's, hey, I'm a real brilliant guy who tinkers and invents things. I didn't invent a clock. I took a clock apart and I put it inside of this thing.
I mean, isn't this a conspiracy theory at this point? I mean, there's no evidence for this. The picture I saw, that display looks awfully large. I mean, you can actually see in the picture there's a plug, so you can get an idea for the scale of the display. And I don't know, that looks like a little bit larger than you'd see in your typical bathroom or bedroom clock.
It certainly does look larger, and maybe he bought a larger clock,
maybe.
But this is a store-bought device that's been taken apart and put inside of another container, right?
Allegedly. So, that's what you're alleging.
That's what I and others are alleging,
all
yes.
All right, Jack, that's what you're saying here, huh?
Well, I agree with you, Ian, that it is kind of a conspiracy theory, but I'm skeptical, and it's starting to have some resemblance with the Balloon Boy hoax. Also, Ahmed's father, Mohammed Al Hassan, has run for president twice in Sudan, and he also defended the Quran in a mock trial against the pastor in Florida did the Quran. So they come from like a really politically active Islamic family, which makes it.
What's that have to do with anything?
Well, it has to do with there could be a political motive behind sending the kid to school and getting him accused of terrorism, right? So if you're a you're a politically active person in a religious context, and you can go and you can say my son was the victim of discrimination at the school, well, that's a political ploy, or is it not?
Well, that
it
seems
can
like,
be used
again,
as one anyway. It's a motive.
We definitely are in conspiracy territory here, right? Like, I mean, who could have known for sure that they would have gone ahead and done what they did?
Are you
right?
Under the impression that presidential candidates don't conspire to do media stunts? Yes,
I'm not saying that.
We are talking about a conspiracy. We're talking about a thing where people have conspired to create a media narrative that is untrue. Yes.
But they couldn't have done it without these overzealous cops and administrators, right?
Like,
there's no way they could have known for sure that this would have happened to Ahmed. This was, you know, if it was what you're suggesting, this conspiracy theory, they were just throwing one out in the water or whatever, you know, throwing something up against the wall to see if it stuck. They couldn't have known for sure that it was going to work.
Well, they couldn't have known for sure that it was going to work, but my understanding of it as well is it wasn't like the first person who saw this thing called it in either.
No, his science teacher told him to keep it in his bag.
Yeah, the science teacher is like, don't show that to people, right? And then what does he do? Oh, and then the thing, what, it beeped or something like that.
Allegedly beeped while he was in his English class.
Yeah, and then the English teacher saw it, and then they're like, hey, look at this, you know. And look, did the school handle it poorly? Sure, no question about it. But it turned into this whole thing of you could have talked about any number of things in the course of this. I mean, the public education system, I have not exactly been a fan of this institution, right?
Mm-hmm.
But it turned into this whole entire thing of discrimination and race pimping and all of this garbage. And I'm like, look, you know, depending on what the device looked like, all right, like I said, my understanding of it was there's wires sticking out of it. Maybe that's not the case. But it did look, it looks like the kid took the thing apart, put it into a different container, and tried to give a certain display to this thing in order to put people on edge. And that goes along with the narrative that his father's a political candidate.
Even if that's true, who cares? And besides that, to say that there's no discrimination going on here is pretty ridiculous, right? I mean, there was some other story. Seven other clock experiments not done by a Muslim boy that were not an issue whatsoever. I mean, so clearly.
And then there was another story where there was a black girl in Florida who had the exact same thing happen to her, and she wasn't
with a
Muslim.
A clock bomb thing?
Yeah, it was.
And then there's white kids that get suspended for Pop Tarts and
exactly
that look like a gun. So
a kid chews up a Pop Tart, he gets accused of weapons. I read a thing on Radical Agenda last night, so I can actually pull the story up if you like. That it's there like 19 ridiculous things that kids have been arrested for at schools.
Yeah.
And if you look
most
of these kids were white in the stories that I was reading.
Right.
So obviously the public education system is a brutally repressive system that is designed
any prison system
to dumb down kids and create a generation of people who are stupid enough to accept every government edict and act of lunacy pushed on them by the state for generations to come. We understand that. I'm not standing up for the school system. What I'm sick of, what I am absolutely infuriated about in this country in general, is this race pimping nonsense that goes on every time something happens to somebody who's non-white, because it's a problem that's going going on in the school system, that you got this paranoid, ridiculous system that is just like, oh, let me just show you my authority, you're going to bend to my will. Well, that's not racial.
And you're right. It happens to kids of all shapes, sizes, and colors, and, you know, male and female both. There's no doubt about that. Jack, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Of course, the headline in this story seems to write itself. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to saveitpurse.com and open an account. Do this right now. Don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to saveitpurse.com right now, get signed up, and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 15 to 25% off of everything at Amazon through saveitpurse.com. It's saveatpurse.com.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
If you're like me, you're concerned about the stock market and the economy. You're asking the questions, but it just doesn't seem that you're getting the right answers. Well, my friends at the Wealth Preservation Institute not only have the answers, but they've put together a free report, How to Survive the Upcoming Economic Collapse and Protect Your 401ks, IRA Savings, and Retirement Income. Don't hesitate. This report's for free for a limited time by calling 888-772-2929. That's 888-772-2929. Take back your financial lives today.
What would your life be like if you woke up each morning with new vitality, feeling better than you have in years, and you noticed a difference in your sleeping patterns, blood sugar levels, and had a sense of well-being overall? There's something that is changing thousands of people's lives, and you could be one of them. It's called Heart and Body Extract. Sharon Harris, co-creator of Heart and Body Extract, talks about the positive effects of Heart and Body Extract.
What happens with the formula Heart and Body Extract is it's giving the body the necessary vitamins, minerals, amino acids, enzymes, and phytonutrients so the body will heal itself. And yes, the body does have the ability to balance blood pressure, balance cholesterol, clean and unclog the arteries. It can also work on balancing the circulation for diabetics. So the body is an amazing thing. It simply needs some help so it has the tools to heal itself.
Heart and Body Extract gets results. To order your 2-month supply, call now, toll free at 866-295-5305. Order online at hbextract.com.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Talk Live, and you're invited here, of course, to join us, talk about whatever you want to discuss. Right now, there's theorizing going on about the Ahmed bomb clock thing, and I gotta say, Chris, I took another look at the photo here of the, it was the police department's evidence that was posted to Wired.com of the device, and you know what? The theory that maybe it was an actual alarm clock that he just dissembled and then put into another case seems to hold some water. They do have that 9-volt there, like the little 9-volt connector that you see in every one of those manufactured alarm clocks. And then as you, our caller Jack pointed out, there was a transformer in there to transform AC into DC power.
Right. I mean, if he just had the 9-volt battery thing in there, then that, this would almost make sense, right? Because he's at school. The thing is, and if it went off, it's there. He says it beeps. It beeps during the English class. Okay. He wanted to show it off to the science teacher, and then while he's in English class, the thing starts beeping. Well, why do alarm clocks beep? It's because you set a timer. Right.
That's usually true. Yeah.
So he's like the science teacher tells him, don't show this to other people. Right. Obviously, the science teacher thinks the thing looks suspicious or something, but the science teacher understands what it is and says, just keep that to yourself. Well, he doesn't want to keep it to himself. So he sets the timer to go off while he's in English class. The English teacher finds it and is like, there's a guy named Ahmed with the timer device that looks kind of, you know, strangely put together. I've been told if you see something, say something. Since 9/11/2001, I see something, I'm saying something. And during the course of the thing, you know, everybody does what government agents do, right? And so I'm not surprised that, look, like I said, it's obvious that once they knew it was a clock, they should have just stopped, right? There's no reason to go sort of put the kid through further trauma, but this idea that he was just, you know, so unfairly racially profiled, it doesn't hold water to me. I think that this
was personally, that's not the direction we came from on Free Talk Live. I mean, this is yet another story of zero tolerance, and zero intolerance generally means zero thinking. These government bureaucrats are these mindless automatons, or at least when they're in their jobs, that's the way they act. Like, must enforce policy, this is illegal. They don't really think, they don't apply any kind of individual circumstances to any case. It's just maximum punishment immediately. In this case, they're not even using internal punishments. They're bringing the police in. And again, this isn't an uncommon story, and I think that is worth pointing out here. But what you're frustrated by is that the media picks up on this as a story, but not all of the other stories about other kids who aren't Muslim folks that have been targeted by various different police.
Well, I would say that I don't expect the media to pick up on every story where a kid gets arrested or suspended
from school.
Because
there are a lot of them.
But what I would say is that what the media is doing is they're pushing this ridiculous egalitarian narrative, okay? And it's a problem because the other thing too, it is, if the kid did it on purpose, all right, which is what it's starting to look like, if that kid went in there with the intention of making his English teacher think he had a bomb, well, then he's going in there and intentionally creating alarm. Okay. And that is something that, yes, if you're intentionally creating alarm, if you're intentionally trying to bait people into coming after you thinking you're a terrorist, well, then that's a terroristic threat. You're trying to create alarm. You're trying to create panic. I'm not surprised that law enforcement gets involved.
Well, I don't know if I agree that that was his intention, but I can understand where you're coming from.
Can you speculate as to why he would make a device that looked like a bomb, be told, that looks like a bomb, keep it in your bag, and then set the alarm to go off in his English class?
Well, we don't know what exactly he was told. The science teacher told him to not show it off to other people. I don't know if he specifically said that it looks like a bomb. And one thing that wasn't
made
clear...
Would you like to speculate as to why a science teacher would tell you not to show something to other people?
One thing that was unclear to me was, what was his motivation for doing this? Was it an assignment for the science class?
No, it wasn't. It is absolutely not. He says in his own video on YouTube, he's like, oh, this is what I do. I invent things. So I invented a clock. Those are his words on his YouTube video, okay? So he's saying, I invented a clock because I invent things. Well, you didn't invent a clock. Hmm. You dismantled a clock, put it inside a suspicious container, were told, don't show it to people, and intentionally set an alarm so that it would go off so that another teacher would find it.
Well, I don't know if I agree with you that that's terroristic threatening. Even if he did what you say he did, Look, man, I was in high school too, and my friends and I screwed off and screwed around and, you know, tried to mess with the teachers as well. And I'm glad that I didn't have to go to prison for any of that.
And he didn't have to go to prison either. Guy got fingerprinted, but I had a situation.
He got arrested.
I worked in a hospital. I worked for a networking company, right? And so we would do like Wi-Fi surveys for hospitals and this sort of thing, and especially so they started going to like electronic medical records. And so I had to plan wireless network installations, and so I would walk around with a laptop that had this program running it and mark out signals on a floor plan, and I would have to leave equipment places and walk away. Yep. Right? And so there was one time when I did this, I came back and my equipment was gone, and I went to security, and these people gave me a really hard time about like leaving a backpack in a hall hallway in a hospital, and they were like, in this day and age, what's wrong with you? And I mean, this was not on September 13th. Yeah. You know, this was a few years ago. And, you know, they gave me as hard a time as you can imagine. They didn't arrest me, but I was an adult in a hospital in a setting, you know,
Let's go to Straight Razor. He's on the line in Texas, listening via TuneIn. Hey, Straight Razor.
Hey, good afternoon. So, one of the problems with all of this, I mean, any of these stories, including this most recent one, is not only is the government bad at keeping people safe, first of all, they're also bad at how they do it. So if I were on, and I am now, you know, private sector, and I work for a rather wealthy man. Now, if I found a device that looks suspicious like this, as the English teacher, if she really thought it was a threat, why was the school not immediately evacuated? If you're really worried about keeping people safe and you think that there is a bomb directly in front of you, why would
she allegedly confiscated it? So obviously she wasn't too concerned.
That's what I'm saying. If you really believe there's a threat, and the same thing for the Pop-Tart guns. If you're really that wacko that you think a Pop-Tart gun is dangerous, then why didn't you evacuate everyone around the Pop-Tart?
Well, I would say, I think in both cases, what they're there is that somebody has, you know, the schools have policies against fake weapons as well, right? Like, you can't bring a toy gun to school and that sort of thing. So it seems to me as though they're realizing that, at least in the case of Ahmed here, they're saying that they're concerned that he's making an attempt to create alarm, and they want to punish him for trying to create alarm.
Well, exactly. But if someone simply confiscates something, was alarm really created? Now, if they had immediately evacuated, I would say, yeah, he caused alarm. But if it's one of two things. Either one, this person was incredibly stupid and didn't realize that maybe the right thing to do would be evacuate in the case of a bomb. Or the other thing is it's all just smoke.
I wouldn't be surprised to find out the English teacher was incredibly stupid.
Yeah. Thanks, Straight Razor. Appreciate it. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. If you want to join us here, you can comment on the alleged bomb clock or whatever happens to be on your mind. Coming up, the crackdown on Uber. One man's going to commit civil disobedience and is.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
This is a healthcare alert from the Pain Relief Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee, back, shoulder, or ankle pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You don't have to suffer any longer. you can immediately qualify for a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost to you by calling our 24/7 pain relief hotline at 866-389-0620. Delivery is free and all paperwork is handled for you. If you are on Medicare and have knee, back, shoulder, or ankle pain, don't wait. You can qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost by calling our 24/7 pain hotline now at 866-389-0620. Our representatives are standing by 24/7 to take your call and rush you your pain-relieving brace at little or no cost to you. Shipping is free and all paperwork is handled for you. Just call 866-389-0620. That's 866-389-0620. Again, 866-389-0620.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Extend your life with ExtendoVite.
Hey neighbor, what are you doing digging? You had a heart attack last year.
Oh, I know. I was told no more hard labor.
Then why are you digging?
Well, I've been taking ExtendoVite. It's been approved to help my heart.
ExtendoVite? Is that a new drug?
No, not a drug. It's more like an herbal combination made from garlic and cayenne.
Herbal? How can that help?
Well, actually, we've taken herbs for thousands of years, and ExtendoVite is doing the job for me.
Does your doctor know about ExtendoVite?
Yeah, my doctor knows, and he said it seems to be working for you, so don't stop taking it. I feel great taking ExtendoVite. I don't want to stop.
To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822, or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with ExtendoVite.
My Patriot Supply is making the choice to get prepared easier and more affordable than ever. For a limited time, a four-week emergency food supply is just $99. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-276-4010 to claim yours. Limit two per caller while supplies last. Get prepared today. Call 800-276-4010 today for your $99 four-week food emergency supply.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free. Our number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And Cantwell.
Also, Uncovering the Secrets and Exposing the Lies. That's what readers of FreedomsPhoenix.com get every day. Readers of FreedomsPhoenix.com are constantly provided detailed real news that lies between the lines of propaganda and the relationship we have with coercive governments. FreedomsPhoenix.com offers up-to-the-minute updates on the economy, technology, communications, and the rise of the police state. Go to FreedomsPhoenix.com and get signed up for the free daily dispatch. That's FreedomsPhoenix.com. As we go to your calls and thoughts, we'll start with Aaron, listening on, or rather calling via Skype. Hello, Aaron. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, Ian and Cantwell. How are you guys doing?
Hey, good. You're calling from Philly. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Yes. I was calling about C. elegans. Mark was talking a little bit last night about his cryogenically frozen head eventually.
What was the word you said you were calling about? C. elegans? What was it?
Sorry, C. elegans.
What is that?
It's a worm. It's a worm studied by biologists as an organism that... as a model organism. So they use it and they try to understand that one perfectly, and then they can kind of translate that to other things that are similar to it.
Is the idea being that this worm, you can freeze it and then thaw it out and it lives? Is that the idea?
Actually, that's not actually the idea.
Oh.
The idea is to understand this worm really well. And Mark was talking about this guy. He read an article about not being able to even reanimate C. elegans. How are you ever going to do it with humans? But I submitted an article to Free Talk Live tonight, saying, which I had just recently learned, that they have animated C. elegans into a robot body. So they were able to take the brain of the worm and put it into a Lego robot and have it behave as a worm.
That doesn't make any sense at all.
That sounds amazing. What? wait, what part's confusing about that, Chris? I mean, they've had, I've seen something on, I forget where the hell I saw it, but a few years ago, where they hooked up some rat to a computer and the rat was able to play video games with its mind.
Yeah, that's essentially what this is they took the connectome. So every neuron has other neurons that it connects to in a certain pattern. And they replicated the pattern of all the brain cells of a C. elegans creature and put it into a robot body and tied the peripherals into the wheels corresponded to what would have been the side muscles on the worm and the sensor at the front. And
I mean, this is sort of the worm equivalent of the prosthetic arm, the robotic arm that someone can control with their brain, right?
Except it's an entire mind. Theoretically, if you think of animals as having a mind, it's the entire mind of an animal.
Wait, I thought you said they took the brain out of the worm and they put it into a robot body. What did I miss?
Sorry, they simulated the brain. So they made a replica of the brain in the program. There's no actual worm parts in there. It's just the mind of the worm.
See, okay, so now you're talking about that they're claiming to have downloaded the brain of a worm matrix style and uploaded it to a computer. I'm having a little trouble with this. Now, the article that he's talking about, I just pulled it up, but it is in the Smithsonian Magazine. I mean, it would tend to be a seemingly
reputable,
credible source here, and it says a wheeled Lego robot may not look like a worm, but it thinks like one after programmers gave it the neuron connections in a C. elegans roundworm.
How do you prove that it thinks like a worm? I mean, is it trying to dig? What does it do?
I mean, this is the thing.
Slithering?
Exactly. It's like if you have a Lego robot that does worm-like things, it's like, is this beyond the capacity of programmers? Probably not. I just watched a whole marathon of BattleBots where they're doing much more complicated things than behaving like worms.
Yeah, why are we supposed to be impressed by this?
So it's not that we can't make things that behave like worms, but it's that the program behind it has been studied and vetted, and there is a publication out there, like a scientific peer-reviewed article, about how they did it, and it wasn't through response mechanisms. It wasn't through if-then computer programming. It was actually through the simulated brain of the worm.
And so they were able to simulate the neurons and all that you claim, and that was made this thing slither. What does it do? Like, it just moves around?
Here, let me read a little bit of this here. If the brain is a collection of electrical signals, then you could catalog all those signals digitally. You might be able to upload your brain into a computer, thus achieving digital immortality.
In theory.
While the plausibility and ethics of this upload for humans can be debated, some people are forging ahead in the field of whole brain emulation. There are massive efforts to map the connections, all the connections in the brain, and to understand how we think. Simulating brains could lead us to better robots and artificial intelligence, but the first steps need to be simple. So one group of scientists started with the roundworm C. elegans, and I can't pronounce what C stands for.
Okay.
a critter whose genes and simple nervous system we know intimately. The Open Worm Project has mapped the connections between the worm's 302 neurons and simulated them in software. Hmm. The project's ultimate goal is to completely simulate C. elegans as a virtual organism. Recently, they put that software program into a simple Lego robot. The worm's body parts and neural networks now have LegoBot's equivalents. The worm's nose neurons were replaced by a sonar sensor on the robot. The motor neurons running down both sides of the worm now correspond to the motors on the left and right of the robot, explains Lucy Black for iProgrammer.
Fascinating.
But this is now it's interesting.
Fascinating.
It's interesting. It's an interesting theory, is what I'll say. Because what you're talking about, okay, so this thing has 302 neurons. They obviously,
this is a very simple organism, right?
Yeah, they took the simplest, you know, quote unquote thinking critter that they could, and they said, okay, we'll map this, and then we will replace these functions with circuits, and they seem to have been able to do that, but I don't know if you can pass this off for a life form, right? I mean, it doesn't seem to me that that's the case. They did not take the worm's brain and move its personality into some other thing.
Well, that's the ultimate question, is if you could duplicate the brain of Chris Cantwell and put that onto the internet or in a robot or something, would it be Chris Cantwell, or what would it be?
Well, I mean, I am matter and energy like everything else.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, there's nothing magical about what's going on in my brain. I mean, it's quite fascinating, a lot of people would like to say, I hope. But it's not magical, right? It's matter and energy. So if you could create the matter and energy in the exact same pattern, then certainly you could, you know, clone Chris Cantwell with all of Chris Cantwell's information and thoughts and whatever.
Well, this is the beginning of that then, right? This is the first step into exploring this. Is that right, Aaron?
Yeah, theoretically, they did clone the mind of a worm, and this worm exists in two places.
No.
But the question...
Did they let the worm meet the Lego version of it? And how large are these C. elegans? I mean, are they like really, really tiny, or are they like the size of your...
Yeah. They're really small. Okay. They're like 102 cells, or sorry, 1,000 cells, something like that.
Oh, wow. Magnitude. Okay. So, yeah, you can't even see it.
No, you need a microscope most of the time.
So this is the largest C. elegans to ever exist, the Lego version. It's like it's like 100 times larger than one of these actual worms.
Right, but if they really did what they said, it's only a matter of complexity and time before they scale up to a mouse or rat or whatever. Yeah. And it brings to mind this idea of... It brings a question ultimately of whether or not human life and what it constitutes, how it's valued. If I have 50 copies of myself, is every single copy of myself entitled to the same rights and privileges as I am?
There are going to be some very interesting questions in this particular realm of, let's say, robot ethics, as things like artificial intelligence and these brain duplications that you're talking about start to really get advanced. I think that there are going to be a number of debates that'll be had over this, and I don't know, you know, what the right answer is there. It's an excellent question.
Right.
Thanks, Aaron.
Yeah, anyway.
Appreciate the call, and thanks for the thoughts here tonight. Our toll-free number is definitely something to think about. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. If you want to comment on the idea of robot people or robot beings at some point, we're going to have them. You know, they're coming. So do they deserve rights just like humans?
No.
Why or why not?
Property.
Let's talk about it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733, Free Talk Live.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates? Or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education? Or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
So I found out the other day that at guns80.com, a lot of people don't get the Ghost AR-15 rifle kits because they're afraid that they won't be able to do the machining work required to drill out and make ready the lower. Well, listen, guys, gals, I am not that good of a machinist, I promise you. But I was able to take a drill press with an XY table and knock this out in about 45 minutes, and in all honesty, mine looks really good. Go get yours. Don't be afraid. It's easy. Guns80.com. Go to guns80.com now.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
Did you know that drinking pure, high-alkaline water is one of the most important factors in maintaining high energy and vibrant health? Most experts agree that the water you drink should be at a pH level of 8 or higher. AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops, available only at AlkaVision.com, combine a unique formula of only the most alkaline minerals. AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops alkalize your water, ridding the body of harmful toxins, and helps you regain health and energy. Alkalizing your water by simply adding 10 drops of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops helps the body rid itself of acidic waste, increases oxygen content, and raises the pH of your body to healthy levels. And bacteria and viruses cannot survive in an alkaline high pH environment. Order your bottle of AlkaVision Plasma pH Drops for only $29.95 at AlkaVision.com. That's A-L-K-A-Vision.com. Or call 269-409-1776. 269-409-1776. Alkalize your body. Supercharge your health at AlkaVision.com today.
Ready Supply Foods sells more food for your money than any other company, and we can prove it. We've gathered nutritional facts from our competitors' own websites and divided them by price to show you how much they sell per dollar. In an emergency, calories mean survival. Ready Supply Foods sells 245 calories per dollar, where the others average only 155. That's 58% more for your money. We're the new leader in value and quality. See the comparisons at ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you in studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Cantwell.
And whether you want to talk about robot worms and robot ethics, should robots have rights? I want to get into that conversation, Cantwell, but I also want to take our calls here because folks have been waiting patiently. So we'll get to those as well. But you can also join us on Skype, just like Aaron did. And you'll sound better on Skype. So connect on Skype at username lrn.fm. How would you like to save 20%? That's the average savings on your Amazon purchases, 20%. Now, the last one I got, 40%. Saved 40% on a Blu-ray. Previous to that, 29% on the pair of headphones that I'm wearing in the studio tonight.
But what do you mean your average savings? Your average savings, like you can't just average save.
My average savings much higher than 20%. The U.S., in the United States, users of Purse, saveitpurse.com.
Oh, when you use saveitpurse.com, you average save 20%.
Thank you. Yes. If you're in the United States, there's different averages for other parts of the world, I guess.
That's a whole lot of white privilege going
on. So as long as you can get, as long as you can have an Amazon delivery to your home, you can use saveitpurse.com. The catch is you have to have Bitcoin. So if you don't yet have Bitcoin, then start thinking about getting Bitcoin, because this alone is reason enough to have Bitcoin. To save 20% or more over at Amazon, that's a reason to go out and get some Bitcoin from expresscoin.com. Go to saveatpurse.com though to get signed up for Purse. Whether you've got the Bitcoin now or not, you're going to want to do this because it's going to save you big time. If you do online shopping at all, you know Amazon, they got a huge selection, great prices as normal. Now, knock another 20% off the already low Amazon prices, and you've got a heck of a deal. So go to saveatpurse.com to get started as we go to your calls and thoughts here. Ron is in, excuse me, getting over being sick here. Ron in Richmond, Virginia, you're on Free Talk Live.
Okay, well, first I'm going to plug Purse for you again. I actually got 30%, and I own about $100 worth of wooden books. I don't know if you're familiar with that line, but it was filled in less than an hour.
Yeah, it's incredible. I mean, you think you're going to have to wait for a while, because usually the higher the percentage you want off at saveitpurse.com, the longer you'll have to wait. And to get 40%, I did have to wait a few days. But you said you saved 30% and only had to wait an hour?
Yep, about an hour, maybe an hour and 15 minutes.
That's pretty sweet.
On your On your other thing, there's a great book by Ray Kurzweil called The Age of Spiritual Machines, and it goes in-depth into what Aaron was just talking about basically having neural networks, like everyone being on the web at the same time that they're kind of experiencing real life, and they're like in a virtual world in like one part of their mind, but they're in the real world in another part of their mind, and like being like cyber cafes, talking to one group of friends while you're actually at an office meeting at work, and that we will be able to partition our brains. It's really cool stuff. But I really recommend anyone who's interested in that, Ray Kurzweil's Age of Spiritual Machines. And it goes into the legal questions, too, about, like, how should we consider these human, android, I guess, machine hybrids.
Well, what do you think? I mean, not necessarily, I don't want to know what Kurzweil thinks. What do you think, Ron? I mean, should these robots, they're coming, right? These robots that will have personalities... And
technically, they're already here.
Yeah.
Technically, they're already here. It's just that, you know, it's like everything. Like, you know, even though everyone says Apple was, you know, when Macintosh was created, that was the age of personal computing. But when you really think about it, personal computing started like basically during World War II. And it just slowly, you know, built up until, you know, it wasn't until the 80s that people realized, hey, we got these things called computers. But before that, you know, only a very select few knew it was there, and it's slowly coming. But I think it's difficult because, say, you clone your own brain, okay, and you have let's say you can create either a biological clone or a robotic clone of yourself, and you map up to the instant of your ceasing of your original body. You map every single experience from in utero to transfer. Then who's to say that's not you? Now, people who believe in a soul or a spirit, they say, well, no, because that's just a copy of you, but there's no real soul. But if you don't believe that, then and the government doesn't, and like law doesn't really purport to a soul because you can't prove it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So from a legal point of view, you would have to say that it would almost be like a transfer of property, right? So, like, if I originally had my body and I wanted to transfer into a new body, I would have to sign over all my rights of existence to that new body. I can't be making multiple versions of myself and all of them have equal rights to whatever I had, because that would just create a lot of problems. You know, that would be opening up
the whole idea of, you know, a robot that is essentially you with all of your brain neurons duplicated, all of your ostensible memories or whatever duplicated, you know, really rises to the question of, or gives new meaning to the question of self-ownership, right? Because you had said, Chris, right before we went to break there, well, this is property, so therefore, in your opinion, the robot should not have rights.
Right, and at the end of the day, what you're going to be end up dealing with, let's just pretend there's a situation where we're just going to sleep at night and plugging ourselves in and backing everything up in case something goes wrong tomorrow, okay? So I get a virus tomorrow and this virus kills me, and I'm like, oh, I'll just go restore the backup. At that point, life is just data, okay? So then it doesn't matter. Our entire concept, this is a ridiculous concept in my book, but if we're going to take this seriously, then we're going to be dealing with a situation where life is basically foundationally valueless, that we could just, like, okay, well, if you kill somebody, you just have to restore the next backup? Like, okay, fine.
Cantwell, can you think outside the box for a minute? Why does a android have to be metal, glass, plastic, or silicon? Why can't it be, say, stem cells that we've programmed to grow into whatever we want it to be?
I didn't say that it can't be.
Okay, well, the way you're talking, like data backups and power, you know, like plugging yourself in, may sound like you're talking about a toaster.
I didn't extract that from what he was saying.
Well, I mean, you're talking about if you can, in some way, whether it's electronic or biological, whatever you want to call it, Ron, at the end of the day, if you can just transfer a person's entire experience into some other vessel, whether it's organic or electronic, at the end of the day, the value of the life is basically the value of the equipment involved, because you're just transferring the experience from one place to another.
Okay, but then if, say, at the same time we're able to, say, turn off the aging, because what we're talking about is basically immortality, right? So if we make, if we take the mortality question out, then the value of life becomes diminished, is what we're saying. But what if we take away the lack of rejuvenation, which would allow us to live potentially as long as we wanted to? would then that also devalue life.
Well, the idea would be that because life would not be as scarce, it would be less valuable.
Yeah, it would not be a scarce resource, right? Like, we value our lives because we each have one of them, right? And so if I am looking at a situation where my experience will continue on for eternity, and I'm like, okay, well, this is just a vessel and I could go replace it tomorrow, right? I could just go take, you know, Christopher Cantwell's sort of like used up overweight body that smoked for a whole bunch of years and just go put it into something else with all sorts of better features for the sake of the radio, then like, what do I care about this vessel? It doesn't matter to me in the slightest. I'll go out and, you know, get shot in the head tomorrow and I just wake up in a better body than the one I have now. Fine.
Ron, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE. But if what you're saying, Cantwell, is that this copy of you, you make this, you know, we're in theoretical realm here. You make the copy of you, but you're still here. The copy of you, you would own?
Well,
and how would that jive with the idea of having a baby, right? Like, you know, there's still kind of a sort of a copy of you there, right? You're at least a portion of your DNA is combining with another person's DNA. You certainly wouldn't argue that you own a baby.
I think by the time that this comes about, I'm going to stop being an anarchist. I'm going to ban this process.
Why is that?
Because it's terrible. This is a ridiculous idea. And by the way, I don't want people to live forever, right? Like, we have to, that's a pretty good process that people live for some period of time and then they go and then there's new people and, you know, you kind of like wash out a lot of bad stuff that way.
So you're not a transhumanist then?
I'm definitely not. I don't want no singularity nonsense. Get out of here with that.
So that's going to be funny, too, because you're going to be on the same side as some of the ultra-religious people. You were already grousing because last week with the Kim Davis situation, you found yourself sort of on the same side as some of these ultra-religious people, and you are a dyed-in-the-wool atheist.
Yeah.
You may discover that once the transhumanists start to get more traction, you know, we get closer to melding ourselves with machines, with robotics, becoming cyborgs, essentially. You're going to see this happening. Improving the human body, some would say improving the human body with this augmentation. There's likely going to be some very ultra-religious people who are going to be very objecting toward this process, and you're on their team.
That's fine with me.
Politics makes for strange bedfellows,
sure
as
does.
They say. 855-450-FREE, that's our toll-free line. Plenty of time for you to join us here. The Uber crackdown continues. One man says he's going to drive anyway. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows, pause and rewind live TV, even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
listening to GCN, the world leader in independent talk radio.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. Angered by a series of controversial videos, the House has voted to place a one-year moratorium of funding for Planned Parenthood.
Part of what critics called a radical pro-life agenda. Indiana's Larry Bouchon.
With all due respect, a radical agenda is protecting an organization that dismembers body parts and sells them for profit.
A complete falsehood was just stated.
Illinois' Jan Schakowsky.
Planned Parenthood does not sell any body parts for profit.
House leaders opted to take up Planned Parenthood funding separate from a spending bill, hoping to lessen the chances of a government shutdown at the end of the month.
Capitol Hill correspondent Wally Hines reporting. In Arkansas, a federal judge has ordered the state to temporarily reinstate its Medicaid contract with Planned Parenthood. Governor Asa Hutchinson last month announced he was terminating the contract. There have been two arrests in Boston in connection with the discovery in June of a little girl's body in a trash bag who became known as Baby Doe. The child's mother is under arrest on a charge of accessory to murder after the fact. The mother's boyfriend has been charged with murder. Massachusetts Governor Charlie Baker says child protective officials at one time had contact with the child.
I think at one point she was involved with DCF for a very brief period of time.
This is the mother of Baby Doe.
Why was she no longer?
My understanding is the case was closed in 2013.
Thousands of migrants were trapped Friday in a vicious tug of war as bickering European governments shut border crossings, blocked bridges, and erected new barbed wire fences in a bid to stem the wave of humanity fleeing conflict in the Middle East and Africa. Asylum seekers who fled westward after being beaten back by tear gas and water cannon on the Hungarian-Serbian border just days earlier found themselves being returned to Serbia, where their ordeal began after Croatia declared it could not handle the influx. On Wall Street, the Dow down by 290 points. More on these stories at townhall.com.
We gave Tom 12 seconds to give six reasons why he opened a Mathnasium Learning Center franchise.
Okay. Great income potential. Doing good for kids. Doing what I love. Making math make sense to kids. 500 centers open already. One every 3 days. Mathnasium taught me the business. Helps me. Supports me.
Time's up. Pretty good. For franchise information, visit Mathnasium.com or take the first step right now. Call 855-361-MATH. That's 855-361-6284.
I don't like sit-down dinners, I don't go to sit-down strikes. I like standing room only, and I don't ride bikes.
This pretty bad song is by a guy with pretty bad hemorrhoids. He needs Preparation H relief with the power of two. First, use fast-acting Preparation H medicated wipes, then longer-lasting Preparation H maximum strength cream.
Let's sit together on the porch swing.
Preparation H. Don't stand for hemorrhoids. Use as directed.
And try specially formulated medicated wipes for women.
The United Nations says 500,000 children have been forced to flee attacks by the Nigerian Islamic extremist group Boko Haram in the past 5 months.
This coincides with a spike in Boko Haram attacks, not only in northeast Nigeria, but also across the borders in Cameroon, Niger, and Chad. Thanks to a regional military offensive earlier this year, the jihadist group no longer controls swathes of territory, but the violence has not stopped and the humanitarian situation remains bleak. UNICEF says in northern Nigeria alone, 1.2 million children have been displaced and over half of them are under 5 years old. Getting help to these remote, insecure areas is extremely difficult.
BBC correspondent Will Ross reporting from Lagos, Nigeria. The Islamic extremist group has been waging a six-year war to take over the country. Persecution of Christians has been especially intense. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. The United States is making it easier for citizens to travel to and do business with Cuba. White House correspondent Greg Klug.
News this hour from townhall.com. I'm Rich Thomason. The House has voted to defund Planned Parenthood for 1 year.
Wisconsin Republican Sean Duffy.
How could any
anybody defend the practices at Planned Parenthood harvesting body parts? How could anyone defend that?
New Jersey's Donald Payne complaining critics are basing their actions on heavily edited YouTube videos.
If you like YouTube so much and that's where you're going to get your information, I have another video you can watch right now on YouTube. It's called Dumb and Dumber.
House leaders hope this vote lessens the chances of a nasty floor fight over a spending bill that could lead.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937. Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
Free Talk Live.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free. 855-450-FREE is our number. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features you'll find there. You can actually create the content right on the front page of the website. Our listeners have done that. You can vote on what they have submitted, or you can submit things right there as well, and it will your submissions will also be voted upon. So go and get interactive at freetalklive.com. With you in studio, it's Ian.
And Cantwell.
We're going to jump right into your calls and thoughts. Coming up, Uber is cracking down, or not, it's being cracked down upon. Uber is not doing the cracking down. They're being cracked down upon in various cities all around the globe, to the point of even being raided in some places. The Uber head office in, I believe it was Hong Kong or Singapore, was raided. And they're not the only ones. I think France conducted a raid against Uber as well.
Raids?
Yeah, dude. These government gangs are dead serious when it comes to protecting the taxi cabs, sort of their oligopoly, their cartel, if you will. Get deeper into that and explain what's happening, where one man is pledging to openly commit civil disobedience and continue to drive for Uber, even though it is prohibited in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. But first, let's talk to Dion, listening in Canada. Dion, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Chris Cantwell.
Hey, how you doing?
What's on your mind?
I just wanted to jump back a little bit on you here about the alarm clock in the case that the 14-year-old brought to school.
Yeah, tell me about it.
I heard this story yesterday. Initially, you know, I thought, oh, some kid makes something and, you know, does a nice job. It's a lot of effort there to put together a circuit and all that and brings it to school, and the teachers freak out over nothing. That was my initial thought. Then I just heard you guys today saying there was some image, so I bring this image up on the internet here. And I am an electronic technician, spent my whole life doing this. And this is quite clearly, without a doubt, 100%, this is a manufactured product that was put into a case.
Why do you say that? Is it because of the transformer with, you know, transforming
sure,
AC
there's,
power?
There's one indication. If you had a kit that you purchased off the internet that you assemble yourself, this is going to be either just the parts themselves that you put into a printed a breadboard, which is just like larger components you plug in temporarily into a board, or you get a PCB printed circuit board that you put all the components in and solder them yourself. One thing you guys had mentioned there earlier, the ribbon wire. So there's a lot of indication this is a manufactured PCB board. One, obviously the ribbon wire goes hand in hand with that board and with that display, which was, you would never get in a kit. You wouldn't get a ribbon wire. You have both the AC and the DC power option, like the transformer, the plug for the wall.
Yep.
That's the AC setup. And then a 9-volt option. So this is not something you would purchase as a kit. This is a manufactured product that was in a some sort of, you know, likely a plastic case or something, an alarm clock.
Yeah, and even if it was a situation where it was a kit that he purchased, right? The kid, if you watch the kid's YouTube video, he's saying, "I invented a clock." Well, first of all, a clock is not an invention in 2015 to begin with. And then even if you went and you got a kit, well, then you're just following instructions anyway. I mean, it might be an interesting thing to learn how to use a soldering iron or something like that.
Right. But he's not inventing it.
Yeah, he's pretending that he came up with this thing as some kind of original project, that he's some kind of whiz kid, and that's not what happened at all.
And even when you say, like, to solder yourself, this was not soldered by hand. I can tell by how rounded off the solder joints are that this was not something where you put the component in and you solder yourself. This is done by a machine. This is a printed circuit board manufactured. On top of which, that's 100% hands down, this is a manufactured product, without a doubt.
Okay.
And a little bit along the lines of speculation, one, where they went through some effort to find themselves a nice jumbo display alarm clock, that's wild, right? Two, this is a nice little perfect low-profile metal briefcase. That was handy. You know, it just looks a little too perfect. To me, this was likely done for the purpose to provoke a situation.
I think so. I totally agree with you.
I would even question, I would put that at 90% at least. I would then question whether a 14-year-old even did this himself. Maybe, you know, less than 50% chance. Like, it looks like likely an adult would have helped him.
Well, it's not that hard to pull guts out of a clock, right? Like,
no,
you go in there, you remove some screws, you put it in this little case, and you're done.
Yeah, that's certainly possible.
Yeah, he'd have been capable of it, but I was the article that I was reading had made the suggestion that that the father was involved with it, and I'm going to try to pull it up and see if there's any actual evidence of that. But, you know, the implication that we were talking about at the beginning of the show was that the father's a politically active guy, and that might have had something to do with this. So if the father's a politically active guy, he wants to make his son appear persecuted. Now he's going to be able to get a picture of himself with President Obama. That's kind of goes a long way if you want to run for president of the Sudan, right?
True to that, yeah.
Dion, anything else you want to share?
No, that's about it.
I appreciate your expertise, Dion.
Thanks for the call. Yeah, great points tonight. I'm sold. All right, so, I mean, it already looked, when I looked at the picture, like it had been pulled from, after it was suggested that it had been pulled from a clock, I could see that. And then his point about the soldering points, I mean, that cinches it right there.
Exactly. So, I mean, this is, whatever's going on here, we know that we're being lied to at the very least, right? It, you know, whether there was sinister intent or political motives, this is all speculation.
Right.
But we know that this is a con
job. He didn't invent
a
clock. It seems pretty clear. At this point, toll free number here, 855-450-FREE. Of course, none of that justifies how he was treated over this thing and the overreaction of the bureaucrats. And of course, again, this is yet another example of zero tolerance, where these bureaucrats, they don't think, they're not encouraged to think, they're not allowed to take each case on its individual merits. And so certainly if they had said in advance, hey, let's go see if those dumb rednecks will do something about this fake bomb or, you know, this clock. And it was their intention to do that. They did get what they intended.
But, I mean, what do you think happened? And the thing is, look, if I go make a fake bomb, Ian, and I go walk into, I'll leave Keene out of it. If I go into the Concord Police Department and I go in there with something that's designed to look like an explosive device, right? Like, I'm not going to have a good time that day, right? Like,
that's true.
It's going to go bad. You don't get to walk around with fake explosives and think that your day's going to go well, right?
But this wasn't a fake explosive. It was just a clock. The guts of a clock in a pencil case. That was the claim.
I think that I am speculating here, of course, but my speculation is that this was and you made the same speculation. That, oh, let's go see if these dumb rednecks fall for us having this fake bomb. Well, that's what it is. It's a fake bomb. So if I go and I go into some other, you know, if I go into some government building somewhere with a fake bomb, you know, I have no right to expect anything other than my day to go really wrong, right?
Toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. You can join us here. Bitcoin, officially a commodity in the United States. We can talk about that. But let's go into the Uber story here. And you're still welcome to join us on robot rights and all of those things if you want to comment at 855-450-FREE. Breaking news over at freekeen.com, where one man who's a Free State Project early mover named Christopher David, is pledging to continue his civil disobedience. He's begun it. He's already taken an illegal rider in his cab, and well, I guess cab's not the right word, in his car, which is an Uber car. He's providing service for people in the Boston and Portsmouth areas here in New Hampshire. And in Portsmouth, they have recently basically outlawed Uber. Now, what they've done, according to SeacoastOnline.com, is they've actually replaced the taxi cab commission with a new commission that's about transportation regulation. So they're trying to write regulations that will allow Uber to legally operate within the city of Portsmouth. But by doing this, they, to their credit, they have lessened the regulations on the taxi companies, but they've also made it, as one of the Uber guys pointed out, draconian and ridiculous ordinances to apply to the Uber drivers. They're mandating that the Uber drivers pass a they're going to have insurance, which they do. Uber requires that the drivers have insurance, and Uber can prove that. But they're also requiring that the drivers pass a criminal background check and also get some sort of placard that they have to put on their dash from the city of Portsmouth that identifies them.
Oh, like those million-dollar taxi licenses in New York City?
they're not as expensive. I don't know what they cost in Portsmouth, but there's a bunch of hoops they want people to jump through, and Uber's not willing to do it. We'll talk about the civil disobedience that is happening here. It's 855-450-FREE.
I walk my dog every day, and I've got the best-looking dog in the neighborhood named Stanley. He's a collie mix. We meet the same people every day. They'll tell me, oh, he's so soft, and he's so silky. And these dogs that have the brittle hair, it's coarse. It doesn't lay nice. It's not shiny. It's dull. I tell them about Dynavite.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Sundance's coat was shiny and glossy the way it had when she was a puppy.
We get asked all the time at shows, how do you get your dog so healthy and shiny and glossy?
It didn't take very long. They've got their nice, expensive jogging suit on, and their dog has their smooth, beautiful, soft, shiny coat. So now their dog looks just as good as they do.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
No! That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
The human body is more than 60% water. Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to AlkaVision.com to find out more. That's ALKAVision.com.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MYTV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
You can join us here on Free Talk Live. All you have to do is dial in toll-free. Maybe you're an angry cabbie who's really upset at these darned Uber drivers out there taking your business.
They're taking our jobs.
Our toll-free number, if you want to join us, 855-450-FREE, because there are some angry cabbies out there. These Uber guys and Lyft, I guess to a lesser extent, you just don't hear as much about Lyft, but Uber drivers and Lyft drivers have been physically attacked by angry cabbies in various different parts of the world.
Brown shirts.
They've been gone after by the government regulators, the government police. In New York City, over 500 cars have been impounded because of a crackdown on Uber drivers. In France and Hong Kong, I believe, Uber's head offices have been raided by police.
What are those things I think you'll see them still in some like Chinatowns and stuff, where like a guy like runs and holds the thing and carries you around. You know what I'm thinking about?
Yeah, I don't know what the name of those things.
I can't recall the name of them, but like it's just
rickshaw.
I could just imagine like the rickshaw providers going and like burning down the Ford Motor Company or something like that. You're putting us out of business.
Yeah, well, in Austin they've got the pedal cabs too. So guys on like bicycles, riding around, taking people places. But Uber, you know, they have, to their credit, they've been fighting it out. They have not rolled over. They have not just bowed out of these various different markets. And it seems like almost everywhere. I'm sure there are some places, in fact, my hometown of Sarasota, Florida, they actually deregulated both Uber and the taxi cab business. So kudos to them for that. They actually made the right choice. But you almost never hear about those stories. It's almost always the government cracking down and targeting these guys.
Well, that's one of them, the planks of the Communist Manifesto, right?
What's that?
I don't have the exact text in front of me. I'll pull it up, but the government wants to monopolize travel, right? You can't have people just traveling freely about a society if you want to control the economy.
Yeah, for sure, and that's certainly something that Uber and Lyft and the other ride sharers out there are threatening. You know, they're threatening the status quo. And that's why the government and these cabbies are so pissed off. They are really upset that someone would come in and dare to innovate in a space that has basically not changed for decades.
Exactly. They've set up this whole apparatus to say like, hey, you know, people could probably drive you around for cheaper, but if we just make it illegal for anybody to drive you around, then I can jack my prices up.
Right. If you don't get the government permit or the $1 million medallion that it costs, I think, or $1.5 million now or something ridiculous like that in New York City, or hundreds of thousands of dollars in other big cities, if you don't get our permission slip, then what you're doing is illegal. And by the way, there's a lot of illegal cabbies in New York City. They're called jitney cabs or gypsy cabs.
Yeah.
And they are relatively prolific. And they're, you know, nice gentlemen. I've ridden in their cabs before.
Yeah, like in New York City, you can call a car service. And normally, right, if you don't need to immediately hail a cab, that's what you'll do in New York City because they're cheaper, right? Mm-hmm. But the way New York City works is the only people who can pick you up on the side of the road is the medallion cabs, the yellow taxis, yeah, right? If a car service sees you on the side of the road with your hands out and mm-hmm. you like look around, I don't see any cops. Yeah, go out and get in, you know? And sometimes people will do that. But I just pulled it up. The 10 planks of the Communist Manifesto. Centralization of the means of communications and transportation in the hands of the state.
Yeah, and you know? It's been in the hands of the state for a long time. They've
exactly.
had that one.
You know, and people will sort of look at, you know, the taxi monopoly and be like, ah, capitalism or fascism. I'm like, well, you know, look, the government tends to like when you just have, you know, a couple of corporations are a whole lot easier for a government to centrally manage the economy than it is for them to manage, you know, hundreds and hundreds of independent contractors just going out and providing goods and services in the marketplace. So they like that stuff.
Well, they want the independent contractors to jump through their hoops. They've made new hoops. For the independent contractors who are working for Uber, because the people working for Uber are not employees. They are contractors. They set their own hours. When you are an Uber driver, Uber doesn't tell you you got to be on shift at 9 a.m. Uber just lets you log in whenever you damn well feel like it. You want to work today? Okay, log into Uber, and you can take some fares.
Right.
It's that simple. And so Uber's not telling you when to show up. They're not providing you with a cab. So they're not a cab company in the traditional sense. Traditional cab company has cabs. They maintain their fleet. It's their responsibility to, you know, if the cab breaks down, it's not the driver who has to pay for that with a cab company. That's the cab company that does that.
Right.
Uber does not have cabs. They don't have their own fleet. They don't have any vehicles.
Right.
Maybe they got one for their executives, but that's about it.
Yeah, each individual driver has his own reputation. You're not dealing with, you know, the corporation or whatever. The corporation is sort of facilitating the communication between you and the driver.
Basically, they're a matchmaker. That's ultimately what Uber does, is they facilitate people who need rides meeting people who have rides.
Yeah, it's like Tinder for transportation.
Without the sex, exactly. Well, maybe there's sex going on in some Uber cabs.
I
don't know.
I'm sure there is.
You know, I think it's a brilliant system.
Probably pay extra.
Have you taken an Uber before?
No, I haven't.
I have, actually. I tried it when I was in Austin this year for a Bitcoin conference. It was my first opportunity, because a year previous, it was illegal to take an Uber cab in Austin. Apparently, it's now they've got some sort of deal where they're able to operate. And it's great, man. You log into the app. And it actually shows you where their Uber drivers are, so you can physically see them on a map, like, oh, there's one right over there. And you let them know, okay, well, I'm ready to be picked up, and then the nearest one starts coming your direction, like, oh, I'll pick you up. And then it shows you the license plate. It shows you the description of the car, so you know it's a red Honda or whatever. And it shows you a picture of the driver, so you know who is picking you up. Right. Of course, each driver has a rating, and you know, they pick you up, and usually, at least of the two rides I've been on, the car's been very nice. It's, you know, well kept, good condition, and the drivers have been personable. So it's been great, and it's cheaper usually than taking a cab would be. So it's like win-win-win all over the place, which is, of course, exactly why the cab companies are livid over this company being out there.
Right, exactly. I've called a number of taxis and taken cabs in New York and stuff like that, and some of these people are not so pleasant to deal with. You know, you get in and they smell bad or whatever. I mean, any number of, you know, terrible things. And, you know, your choice in that is like, well, I better, you know, look out for that driver when I'm hailing these identical taxis on the side of the highway.
Know?
You know, it's ridiculous. You just have no choice in the matter.
So there's so many different reasons why people would want to take an Uber, and they are providing fresh competition into this business. And of course, the way government regulation works is they are protecting, not the consumers. That's what they claim. Oh, we're here to keep the consumers safe from these unscrupulous cab companies and Uber. We don't want them taking advantage of the customer.
Yeah, right. You know, you're making sure that the cab companies take advantage of me and your medallion holders and that sort of thing.
They're protecting the cabbies. They're protecting the people who for decades have paid for these medallions, who for decades have jumped through all of these hoops, and who now are basically a cartel. In fact, the story here from SeacoastOnline.com, and I've sort of used some of their stuff on my piece over at FreeKeen.com, but I really want to share this story from Seacoast Online, because it's all about these cabbies snitching. They have vowed to become a snitch squad for the Portsmouth Police Department. Because, you know, their cabbies are all over the city. They know ostensibly who the Uber drivers are because they've got the Uber app. So the cabbies have the Uber app, and they are looking on the streets for Uber drivers to then call the police department and snitch out their competition.
Well, I think somebody should start calling in hit and runs on every cabbie in Portsmouth.
Hit and runs. What do you mean?
Just say they hit my car and ran. Just dial 911 every 15 minutes and call it in on cabs. Just lie.
Toll-free number. No, that's fraud. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. There's got to be more creative options than that.
My name's Clyde, age 59, and I reside in Florence, South Carolina. The doctors diagnosed me as having clogged arteries. It felt like I was carrying heavy concrete blocks around my feet and legs. I started taking Heart and Body Extract as directed. It is less than 3 weeks, and I'm like a young man again. It's unbelievable that an herbal formula can work so fast and so powerfully.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
So I found out the other day that at guns80.com, a lot of people don't get the Ghost AR-15 rifle kits because they're afraid that they won't be able to do the machining work required to drill out and make ready the lower. Well, listen, guys, gals, I am not that good of a machinist, I promise you. But I was able to take a drill press with an XY table and knock this out in about 45 minutes, and in all honesty, mine looks really good. Go get yours. Don't be afraid. It's easy. Guns80.com. Go to guns80.com now.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be The Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
My Patriot Supply is making the choice to get prepared easier and more affordable than ever. For a limited time, a four-week emergency food supply is just $99. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-276-4010 to claim yours. Limit two per caller while supplies last. Get prepared today. Call 800-276-4010 today for your $99 four-week food emergency supply.
Does being over 40 make you feel like half the man you used to be? You feel more tired, out of shape, not in the mood like you used to be? Thanks to an exclusive formula, you can help boost testosterone levels safely and naturally. Introducing Ageless Male, a life-changing supplement for men tested to help increase testosterone levels.
You'll notice a boost in your energy levels. Workouts work, sex life improves. It's like a light switch goes on.
Try Ageless Male risk-free if you would like to experience what taking Ageless Male can feel like. Support for healthy, normal testosterone levels, healthy energy, and increased performance, and more romance when you want it.
Call 1-800-327-4821. That's 1-800-327-4821. 800-327-4821. 800-327-4821. That's 1-800-327-4821.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can join us here. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. Maybe you're an angry cabbie, and you want to tell us why Uber's so bad and dangerous for people. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, because there are a lot of cabbies out there who are upset about Uber. Now, the smart cabbies are probably doing some Uber in their off time, you know, because they see the writing on the wall that the old ways are dying off. And despite the thrashing of the state regulators and the angry cab owners and drivers, you really aren't going to be able to stop this progress. I mean, Uber has been doing a great job at defending their drivers. They, in a lot of cases, are pledging. I think they just have this general pledge that if one of their drivers gets a ticket, that Uber will help them challenge it in court. I believe they will pay for attorney's fees and or pay the ticket ultimately if they have to.
I got to imagine that that's getting expensive.
Yeah, it's amazing that they can even it's amazing they can keep the prices down given the amount of money. Their legal department at Uber, I don't know how many attorneys they've got on staff, but it's got to be a crap load of them because there must be dozens and dozens of open cases in cities all around the globe, not just in the United States, but around the globe. These Uber companies are being just embattled by state governments that are trying to outlaw them across the state, city governments that are trying to prohibit them from doing business or regulate them into the ground. I mean, it's just insane how much money they must be spending on lawyers.
Yeah, I know. I've heard about, you know, lawsuits and regulations and that sort of thing. I mean, you had mentioned before one of the earlier breaks that they were actually being raided in some places. Yeah. That I was not aware of. I'm like, really? Is it really getting to that point that we actually have to go and start kicking down doors and throwing flashbangs in order to catch the computer programmers that are just facilitating transportation? People, come on. How bad does it get?
That is how bad it's gotten. And you know, it's going to get worse before it gets better, but overall for the riders out there, it's gotten better. Taking Uber is in a lot of cases a step above getting in a cab, and the cab companies don't want to compete. They want to outlaw their competition. We'll continue that discussion here and tell you about how the cab companies in one town, Portsmouth, New Hampshire, are planning to snitch on the Uber drivers around town. But I also want to let you know about ExpressCoin.com, because I actually saw the other day that there's some website, and I'm sorry, I don't remember what it is. I can probably pull it up somehow here. But there is a website that is now actually allowing people to pay for Uber with Bitcoin.
Nice.
Now, this, like a lot of things with Bitcoin, it seems like it's kind of a workaround system, like not necessarily that Uber is
some kind of third-party transaction facilitator.
They're not, Uber themselves are not directly integrating Bitcoin. Okay, here it is. A website is called bitcoinbuilder.com. It's not an advertiser, so I don't know how good they are, how well this works. I haven't tried it myself. But bitcoinbuilder.com allows you to set up an account that you can somehow actually access through the Uber app. So there is some level of integration from Uber for this.
Nice.
And so, yeah, there you go. Another reason to get Bitcoin. ExpressCoin is the way to go for it. Bitcoin, Litecoin, Dogecoin, you can get all those from ExpressCoin. The best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. And they're a licensed money services business. You can get cryptocurrency with money order or check. Just start off at ExpressCoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, you can probably be served by ExpressCoin.com. You can even do it from your smartphone by downloading their app. Get started at ExpressCoin.com, and don't forget to use coupon code FTL, like Free Talk Live. You'll get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency with no transfer fee when you use coupon code FTL at ExpressCoin.com. Let's go to Charlie. He's listening to KTOX in Arizona. Hey, Charlie.
Yeah, hello. I think this thing with the taxis is pretty much par for the course. It boils down to it's just legalized extortion, just like mandatory insurance. They get rid of competition. The companies can drive up prices, and they have the full force of the state to make sure that they get their money.
I was shocked when I first moved to New Hampshire because we don't have compulsory insurance here, right?
Yeah, is it one of the only states?
It's one of few.
Yeah.
And so I'm from New York, and I don't have to rattle off the exact numbers here, and I don't recall them off the top of my head, but it was my liability insurance was cut by probably more than two-thirds.
I knocked a couple hundred bucks a year off of mine when I moved here.
I'm sure, and they're all connected. All they have to do is pull up behind you, run your plate, and they know. They cancel your license, they cancel your registration, and that's when they get you. It's because they can arrest you for those offenses.
Oh, they sure do. That's one of the problems we do have here in New Hampshire. Is they're relatively nasty when it comes to people driving without a government license. They will come down pretty hard on those folks. Hey, Charlie, thanks for your... Go ahead.
People can't afford it. You know, once they lose their car, they lose their job.
Oh, yeah. You get stuck in a rut, and then, you're not allowed to drive to go and get work, so you're screwed.
Yeah, New Hampshire, they got that...
Welcome to the plantation.
They got that habitual offender thing where you can actually get jammed up on a felony. You get caught a few times, and it's like, really? Like, I went to work, and now I'm a felon? Thanks,
I was
pal.
In jail with a guy... Thanks, Charlie, for your call. I was in jail with a guy when I was there for civil disobedience. He was there for going to work without a government permission slip. And it was X amount of times that he'd been caught over 2 decades or whatever. And so they finally put him in for a year. He was sentenced to a year in jail. And there was a real study in contrast, too, because when I was in there, while I was there for the 2 months I was there, there were 2 DUI cases that came in. One, 3 days. Another, 21 days. So to the state, it's no big deal if you go driving drunk down the highway, possibly putting people in danger. But if you're just driving to work without the government permission slip, nail them to the wall.
Oh, I mean, at the end of the day, the drunk driving laws are thought crimes, too.
I think we should repeal those, too.
And if you were a habitual offender drunk driver, you'd be in the same spot, right? So that's what the guy got locked up for was habitual offender status.
Yes, that's correct.
And if you can get a habitual offender drinking and driving, I mean, it's a serious traffic infraction, just like driving without a license.
Yeah, that's true.
It's just that they didn't, somebody gets a couple of DUIs, they'll often stop before they get to the point because you have the more serious repercussions right away, whereas, you're driving without a license, they give you a ticket, you don't answer. You're driving without a license, you get a ticket,
and
you don't answer.
And then all of a sudden it escalates.
And all of a sudden they're like, hey, wait a second, now you're going to jail. Whereas you get caught drinking and driving, you spend the night in jail, you're like, whoa, I better think twice about that.
Portsmouth, New Hampshire, Seacoast Online reporting, after the city's new transportation services ordinance takes effect Thursday. This was written just 2 days ago. So it has now taken effect. At least one city cab driver is boosting his rates, and many others plan to police for rogue drivers. The cabbies vow to monitor the local Uber app and to take photos and drop dimes whenever they see any of the 50 known Uber drivers who've been working in the city. Merle Crabby Cabby White, owner of Anchor Taxi, told Police Chief Steve Dubois Wednesday he'll hand over a list of 50 license plates that local cabbies have compiled and reportedly belong to vehicles driven by part-time Uber drivers. Quote, all the taxi companies will be writing down license plates, and we expect the police department to enforce, unquote. The new ordinance, according to Great Bay taxi owner John Palerio, he told the taxi commission during its final meeting on Wednesday morning. Effective Thursday, it will be known as the Transportation Services Commission. So no longer are they the taxi commission. No, they're the Transportation Services Commission. Also, starting Thursday, City Attorney Robert Sullivan said the only way the public will know if a driver is legal is by looking for a placard identifying them as authorized to pick up passengers in Portsmouth. Said placards must be prominently displayed, cite the name of the company providing rides, and approved by the city clerk's office. Otherwise, said Sullivan, the vehicle that picks them up is in violation. Violators will be cited and faced a $500 fine for their first offense, and then $1,000 fines for subsequent infractions, according to New Transportation Services Ordinance.
$1,000 for giving somebody a lift.
Yeah, that's right. And there's one man who is openly defying this ordinance. He is committing civil disobedience, and he is willing to be identified for it. His picture, his name, details about him are up over at freekeen.com. We'll tell you more about what these cabbies are doing to try to stop competition. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free, with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now, 1-800-719-9349. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now. 1-800-719-9349. That's 1-800-719-9349. 1-800-719-9349.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American-made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
Most of us already know that taking a fish oil supplement to boost omega-3s is a good idea. But did you know that about 60% of Americans are actually deficient in omega-3s? Did you know that most fish oil products contain only about 25% omega-3s and the remaining 75% is undesirable fish fat? Heck, did you know that more than 90% of fish oil supplements sold in the USA are not even made here? If you want to boost your omega-3s using the finest American-made fish oil, check out Nutrigold Fish Oil Supplements on www.fishoil.best. Nutrigold fish oils are independently 5-star certified and guaranteed to be exceptionally pure. That means no more fish burps. Best of all, just one Nutrigold fish oil capsule contains more omega-3s than 4 standard fish oil capsules. Go to www.fishoil.best or call 888-920-1497 and use promo code BESTFISHOIL to get a free 1-month supply. That's www.fishoil.best or call 888-920-1497.
Ready Supply Foods sells more food for your money than any other company, and we can prove it. We've gathered nutritional facts from our competitors' own websites and divided them by price to show you how much they sell per dollar. In an emergency, calories mean survival. Ready Supply Foods sells 245 calories per dollar, where the others average only 155. That's 58% more for your money. We're the new leader in value and quality. See the comparisons at ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here. Toll free number is 855-450-FREE. And if you care about your privacy while you're on the internet, you need ProXPN. It's a virtual private network. They encrypt your online data, which means your internet service provider, they won't know what you're doing anymore with their internet connection once you start using ProXPN. And ProXPN does it right, offering OpenVPN, the gold standard of network encryption. They've got apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and Linux support as well. Go get started at ProXPN.com. Use code FTL50, and you'll get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of your account. When you buy an annual account with our code, FTL50, it can end up being cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee. Plus, unlike those other guys, ProXPN keeps no logs of your activities whatsoever, and they've got more servers now than ever before, giving you greater speed and security. So get started over at ProXPN.com and use code FTL50 to get a huge discount and take back the privacy that is your right. Let's go to Jay Noon. He's on the line one of the amp lines. Hey, Jay.
Hey, just listening to you guys as usual, and I ended up, just wanted to comment that I been summoned, arrested, whatever, several times for driving without a license because I don't have one and I'm not getting one.
It's awesome.
And probably 30, 40 times at least I could think of.
Wow.
And I've only lost two of them, two of the actual cases.
Really?
And those ones that I lost, they were reduced from criminal to civil. And, you know, which is just a bench trial, no jury or anything.
Mm-hmm.
And one other time it actually made it to a jury, and I beat the charge at a jury level. But all the other times, it's been dismissed. And the last time I was in court over this issue was dismissed the very first appearance.
How's it getting dismissed, Jay? Because my understanding is it's generally pretty illegal to drive without a driver's license, and you say that you've been, you know, caught doing this explicitly over and over and over and over again, and judges are just like, hey, you seem like a swell guy. I don't feel like giving you a trouble today, so you get to go home?
Well, usually it's the prosecutor who dismisses it. It's not too often the judge does it. The last time I was in court, the judge did it. Because the prosecutor remained silent. But I just kept the last thing I did in court, which is a lot of fun, and I love doing this strategy because it's so much fun, is who's the injured party? And they say it's the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. So I say, well, I'd like to speak with Mr. or Mrs. Commonwealth of Massachusetts because if I've injured a man or woman, I want to make them whole again. I believe in libertarian ways, and if I cause damages, I believe that, or I will create a remedy, or I will whatever they want for remedy.
Mm-hmm.
But quite simply with the prosecutors is going and talking to them before your court date. And what I do is I show them their own code and I explain to them how it doesn't apply to me, because in Massachusetts and New Hampshire, I've been digging into the New Hampshire stuff because this is one of the activism I'm going to do when I get up there. Is travel around without license plates, without a license, because, well, this is something I want to do.
I love it. I'm so excited about it, Jay, and I'm looking forward to getting some of this on the record because, you know, I believe you when you say this. I mean, we've met a number of times. You are somebody who really does live by your principles. You are the same man, for those who maybe are newer listeners to the show. Jay actually put his own house on the line over a property tax issue, and it was stolen from him by the town of Palmer, Massachusetts, because he hadn't paid the property taxes and made a stand on that. So this is a guy who's willing to put his own house on the line for his beliefs, unlike a lot of people who talk about their courtroom theories and never actually put them into to play. Jay, you actually do this stuff, and so I'm excited about actually getting some of this documented, because you know, you've got a lot of great stories, but it only really matters when we can get it on video.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to you doing it out here, Jay, because if I'm entirely honest with you, I have a hard time believing it, okay? I've seen a lot of people try and explain to prosecutors that the laws of the state don't apply to them, and it's got a terrible track record. Most people who do that, they're lucky if they don't wind up in contempt of court. But, I mean, you've got these amazing stories, so when you do come to New Hampshire, I mean, we'll have cameras in the courtroom, and then people can see it for themselves.
Can I just take a minute and quickly explain what it is I do? So
sure.
What I do is the driving code says a person operating a motor vehicle, very first. So what I do is I open up to MGL Chapter 7, Section 4, Paragraph 23.
What's MGL?
Which is the Massachusetts General Laws.
Okay.
Which are not laws, they're codes. They were all codified in 1920-something. Anyways, it says the definition of person: corporation, trust, association, or other entity, societies, and something else. It doesn't say man or woman. And then a motor vehicle is defined as, you know, basically being used for a commercial purpose. So I explained to them, according to your own code, I'm not a person, because a person is a corporation. And they're like, well, it means that it could be a man or woman. I say, absolutely not. It's because it says right in the beginning of the definitions that they have these words defined below have the exact definition. And that's usually how I go about it with the prosecutor. And then when it comes to the definition of the word state, and I went through this with Renee last summer, and I explained to her a little bit about this. You look up the word definition of the word state in your New Hampshire code, and it's the same in everyone I've looked. It says state, District of Columbia is what the definition of state is. So when
sounds
they
unbelievable.
Say the state of New Hampshire,
I don't.
Right. Well, I just look it up. It is unbelievable.
Wow. Well, Jay, I think it's fascinating stuff, and look forward to seeing you when you get back up here. Thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You know, there are a lot of courtroom theories out there, and most of their proponents have never actually tried to put them into to play.
Okay, so I'm looking at the Massachusetts legislature. As used in this chapter, the term person includes one or more individuals. That's right there.
Yeah.
One or more individuals, partnerships, associations, corporations, legal representatives, trustees, trustees in bankruptcy, receivers, and the Commonwealth, and all political subdivisions, boards, and commissions thereof. So right, the first thing that it says is, as a person, is individuals, and that is absolutely
now. Is that from the
about,
driving code? Is that from the
is
motor vehicle?
MALegislature.gov.
Because I mean, obviously, we don't have Jay on the line now at this point. I wish we still did, but you know, maybe the claim would be that oh well, it's defined differently in another place. Because one thing that is true about government statutes is they can redefine words as they see fit. So if person means one thing in one place, it could be redefined in the motor vehicle statutes to mean something else. But I'm with you, Cantwell. I'm a skeptic, right? Like, and Jay knows that I'm skeptical of a lot of the stuff that he says.
There's trial video of you trying to challenge the jurisdiction of courts in Keene, and it did not work out well.
I fail miserably.
There's other things. You know, you could go look on YouTube for all of this different sovereign citizen stuff, and it does not pan out. So understand, when you hear Jay call in here, ladies and gentlemen, it ain't legal advice.
That's true.
You know, if you want to go look into some of this stuff, you can spend a lot of time researching it, and you can go down some really crazy rabbit holes. I spent a lot of time going through this thing, creditors in commerce. You ever heard of these guys?
Yeah.
Oh my
these
god,
the people that are trying to what is this? This is the thing where they believe that you have some sort of mystery account that has hundreds of thousands of dollars in it, and that you can just pay all your bills with it.
Oh
or
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah. What you do is it's crazy. So it starts off. I start on this after I get out of jail for DWI, right? Uh-huh. And I'm like, okay, I'm done with the driver's license thing. The driver's license is tyranny. I'm not doing this anymore. And I start listening to all this sovereign citizen stuff, and I find out these creditors and commerce guys have these like podcasts and
just
presentations.
Just right, accept it for value
do.
On it.
Yeah, exactly. They start with this. Oh, you're just this is how you don't pay your bills, and here this is how you get the IRS to reimburse you for all the checks that you wrote. And I'm like, wait a second. And I'm like, I'm really glad they went into all that crazy nonsense, so I realized these people are not credible.
Yeah. So you didn't try it then?
No. I mean, I drove around without a license for a long time, but just hope not to get caught, and luckily didn't.
Look, I agree with you. The people out there that are advocating that you can just somehow write some magic words on an invoice and get the government to pay your bill for you is, you know, it should be obvious that you're going to be throwing up a red flag and that you will be prosecuted for fraud. By doing
even the notion that you know that you could just go challenge your jurisdiction and there are these ways around the laws. Like if this was the case, then like we would not have a problem, right? If this is all just voluntary compliance and people just opting in and out of the system, then I would not be doing this, right? Like I would not live in New Hampshire. I wouldn't be doing propaganda for a living. I'd be like, fine, if I can opt out, I'll opt out. Leave me alone.
Right, which is why a lot of these theories, they're not going to work consistently across the board. If somebody is getting out of some sort of criminal charge by uttering some magic words, it's probably just a coincidence. Unless you can get those magic words or whatever the theory is to work consistently, and you can get evidence of it working, you just have a theory. It's Free Talk Live. Share your thoughts.
If you expect secure, privacy-oriented services and real human support from your web hosting provider, choose Virtual Space International. From domain names and SSL certificates to offshore banking accounts, Virtual Space International has been the all-in-one, multi-language solution for over 25 years. And satisfaction is guaranteed or your money back. We even accept Bitcoin. Find out how to get 50% off for life at SaveTimeHosting.com.
Want gold but also want to stay digital and decentralized on the Bitcoin blockchain? Anthem Vault providing trusted, world-class vaulting, has your answer with Hayek Gold. Digital, spendable gold inspired by economist and free market philosopher F.A. Hayek. Each Hayek is worth 1 gram of gold and is available right now at AnthemVault.com. Sign up today at AnthemVault.com with promo code FREEDOM to earn 6 months of free storage and 5% off all margins for life. Hayek Gold at AnthemVault.com. Get yours today.
Hi, my name is Scott Fuchs, teacher and rowing coach for over 14 years. I was sluggish, overweight, on prescription drugs, and only 30-something. Fortunately, I was referred to Dr. Z, and happy to say Dr. Z's all-natural protocols over a consistent course resolved my health issues. I'm in the best shape of my life, and most importantly, on zero medications.
I'm Dr. Zdanowski, author of Evology. Trained as a primary care physician, surgical manipulation under anesthesia, expert in nutrition, diet, weight loss, immune system, and I specialize in chiropractic. My 15 years of professional experience has taught me the four keys to vibrant health: a balanced musculoskeletal system, an integrated nervous system, a flowing lymphatic system, and a body filled with over 90 essential nutrients. This has been a secret too long. Actualize your potential, reverse disease. Call me, Dr. Z. 201-945-1177, 201-945-1177, evolveyourself.com.
You're listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. The House has approved a bill that would defund Planned Parenthood for 1 year. That vote was 241 in favor and 187 in opposition. Congresswoman Debbie Wasserman Schultz says there is no evidence of wrongdoing by Planned Parenthood.
Republicans' own investigations turned up nothing, yet some of their members are willing to risk women's lives just to score political points. Enough is enough. I urge all members who truly value women's health to vote against this outrageous witch hunt.
The GOP is forging ahead, sparked by the recent videos released by the Center for Medical Progress showing Planned Parenthood officials discussing how they take tissue from aborted babies for medical research and profit. House Majority Leader Kevin McCarthy says the videos make clear the organization shouldn't get any taxpayer money.
In the face of these videos, and with all the alternatives women have for health, why would you want to force your constituents to pay for something so evil?
The EPA's Cynthia Giles says Volkswagen has been ordered to fix 500,000 VW and Audi diesel cars made in the last 7 years that have software that evades EPA emission standards.
Put simply, these cars contain software that turns off emission controls when driving normally and turns them on when the car is undergoing an emission test.
The EPA calls the company's use of the device illegal and a threat to public health. VW said in a statement it is cooperating with the investigation. Suffolk, Massachusetts County District Attorney Daniel Conley says authorities now know the identity of that dead little girl who came to be known as Baby Doe.
Based on interviews and evidence recovered pursuant to multiple search warrants executed during the past 24 hours, the child that we all came to know as Baby Doe has been identified.
Her name is Bella Bond. The boyfriend of Bella's mother has been charged with murder. On Wall Street, the Dow by 290 points. More at townhall.com.
There are times when people need a little extra money, honest, hardworking people, and some banks don't always make it fast or easy. But finally, there's a company who gets it who could help my listeners that need it, Avant. You simply go to avantoffer.com on your computer or phone to check your rate risk-free with no effect on your FICO score. Complete your application in minutes and the funds could be in your account as soon as tomorrow. If any of my listeners need a loan between $1,000 and $35,000, go to avantoffer.com. Avant will give you a $50 Amazon.com gift card after you make your first payment on time. For this offer and to check your rate risk-free, go to avantoffer.com and enter promo code BORROW. That's AVANTOffer.com, promo code BORROW, avantoffer.com, promo code BORROW. Loans made by WebBank and by affiliates Avant Incorporated. California loans offered by Avant are made under finance lender's license number 603K124. Funds are generally deposited via ACH for delivery next business day. If approved by 4:30 p.m. Central Time, Monday through Friday. Amazon is not a sponsor of this promotion. Other restrictions apply. See website for details.
Areas of Wisconsin and Minnesota are leading the fight for communities to become what they call dementia-friendly. In Watertown, Wisconsin, the effort includes a memory cafe, a monthly coffee shop support and social group for people with dementia and their caretakers. Bernice Hines says the support group benefits her and her husband, who has dementia.
It lifts my spirits. It makes me have a better day for both of us.
Jan Zimmerman, director of Dementia Ministries for the Lutheran Home Association, says Watertown is positioning itself as a place where people with these issues can find support.
Our goal is to help educate the community, help get rid of the stigma that's still associated with it, and to create a community that those living with dementia are still a vital part of.
In Minnesota, a website offers advice on how to be dementia-friendly and includes downloadable documents, training videos, and statistics. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. It is National Prisoners of War Mission in Action Recognition Day today. Defense Secretary Ash Carter says one of the tragic realities of war is the possibility of personnel being captured or lost.
Today, we remember that even when war ends, not everyone comes home.
Speaking at a Pentagon ceremony today, Carter says the Pentagon is using advanced technology to put names to the remains of military personnel found decades after their deaths.
Investments and advances in forensic science will allow us to identify the previously unidentifiable remains of some of the fallen.
Secretary Carter pledged never to forget, saying there are still more than 83,000 Americans missing from World War II, Korea, the Cold War, and Vietnam. Similar events were held in places like Florida and Texas. It's held annually on the third Friday of September. More on these stories at townhall.com.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at patriotnecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
Patriotnecklace.com?
Patriotnecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from patriotnecklace.com.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can join us here toll-free, 855-450-FREE. Got more to say about this Uber situation. They are under fire in cities all across the United States and around the world, with the attacking going as far as actual raids on Uber's head offices in countries, including France, I believe, Hong Kong also. You can join us here, share your thoughts. Maybe you're an Uber driver, or maybe you're a passenger, or maybe you're an angry cabbie who wants to put a stop to this competition, because that's what's happening here is the cab drivers are teaming up with the police in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. At least they're going to be snitching to the police. Whether the police will take action is remains to be seen. There is one Uber driver in Portsmouth who is swearing that he's avowing that he's continuing civil disobedience. His civil disobedience started yesterday, apparently, when this new taxi cab regulation went into place. His name's Christopher David. You can see his picture and more details about him over at freekeen.com. He said his first illegal fare was an older gentleman who was very excited about being taking part in civil disobedience, and then had several choice words that we can't air here on the radio to say about the Portsmouth City Council. So things are already getting interesting.
So when these jurisdictions pipe up and start trying to clamp down on Uber, Uber does not like shut down their system in the area then?
Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. I'm not sure by which measurements or what factors lead them to shut it down. Because when I went to Austin 2 years ago, I thought, oh, I'm going to try Uber out. We were at the airport and we realized we hadn't figured out how the hell we were going to get to the hotel. So I thought, all right, well, let's try Uber out. And I got the app, installed it, and it told me, we're sorry, but due to ongoing negotiations with the city, we can't provide you with service at this time.
And they're using the word negotiations pretty loosely there, it sounds like.
And then a year later, I was able to use the app in Austin. So what cleared up, I'm not real sure about that. And it is definitely confirmed that Uber is still available in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. The app is still running. You can still download it. You can still hail an Uber driver, if you will. So whatever the reason, they have not decided to discontinue service. And further, Uber generally stands by their drivers, saying that they will help them in the event of a legal instance. So if they get targeted by the police, fined, they might help them in court. They might pay the fine for them. I suspect they're going to, you know, try to take it to court and at least challenge it first. And the driver in this case, Christopher David, does say that he intends to draw this out. He's not going to take a plea deal. He believes he's not doing anything wrong. There's, you know, he's not going to plead guilty if he's not guilty of anything. In this case, he doesn't think that taking someone from point A to point B is a crime. So I'm with him.
I'm absolutely with him, too. I wonder, has Uber said anything about it yet?
No, there's no official communication that he has from Uber. They have not told him to stop. They have not told him to go. They have not told him anything. So he's just going to continue doing his Uber thing. And in fact, he points out that he doesn't actually do Uber full time. It's just something he does on the side, and he had not been doing it really at all recently. But as soon as the ordinance passed, he was so upset, he decided he was going to start doing some more driving for Uber.
That sounds like as good a reason as any.
Yeah, I love this guy. I think he's great. So here's what he's up against. Violators will be cited. This according to SeacoastOnline.com. Violators will be cited and face a $500 fine for a first offense and $1,000 fines for subsequent infractions, according to the new Transportation Services Ordinance. Now, get this. They claim the ordinance was written to allow Uber and other ride-sharing companies to work in Portsmouth, as though you need to have some sort of city ordinance to allow people to do business in a place. No, you just let people do their thing.
Right. That's not how allowances work, right? Yeah. It's legal until you ban it. And if you're talking about a society where we have to pass laws to make things legal before they can happen, then sorry to tell you, Portsmouth, you're talking about a dictatorship.
Yeah, this is not freedom. It's not live free or die. It's an embarrassment. And so anyway, going on here, it says that it's allowing these companies to work in Portsmouth and requires proof of commercial insurance and criminal background checks for all drivers. When the Taxi Commission met Wednesday, city officials reported unanimously that no rideshare company had applied to operate under the new ordinance. Uber had not filled out an application to operate in Portsmouth, according to the city clerk's office. Uber had not provided proof of commercial insurance, said Sullivan, although in a different article, Uber says they provided the insurance proof to the city multiple times, but they disagree with the driver's background checks, which, according to another story at Seacoast Online, the background checks prohibit anyone from driving for in the city of Portsmouth who has had a felony or misdemeanor in the last 7 years. So doesn't matter what their driving history is, although that's a factor too. Like if you've got some bad driving history, you'll be disqualified. But if you've had a misdemeanor, which is super easy to get, even felonies are pretty easy to get these days, but misdemeanors are super easy to get, you can't drive a car in Portsmouth, New Hampshire.
That's pretty rude. Well, you can't drive a car as a transportation business.
Driver, for somebody else. And so in addition to that, they also have to get some sort of placard, which requires them to jump through hoops at the city clerk's office. And one of the Uber representatives has called all of this draconian. He says that the requirement forces drivers to navigate a burdensome government process to obtain this placard that is supposedly issued by the city clerk. So if you don't have their placard, you get fined, is basically how this is going to work. The city's drivers, they say, have all complied. The taxi drivers have complied with the new ordinance. And let's see, Polario, this is one of the taxi cab owners in town, told the commission he thinks the police department should designate an officer to look for unregulated drivers and to summons them. He told the Portsmouth Herald that his commercial insurance averages about $5,500 per vehicle annually. White told the commission that, and White is another one of the cab company owners, told the commission that, quote, it's time Uber does it our way or they get out of the city.
You do what we say or we're going to come down on you like a ton of bricks.
And this is one of the cab company owners, right? I mean, he's talking like he's in a criminal cartel.
Yeah. I mean, he is. He's
exactly.
Like, he's like, hey, look, we've sort of got this racket going on here, and if you want in on it, pal, you're gonna do it my way, you see?
He said his commercial insurance, because his company is smaller than Polario's, is about $8,000 a year. Rockingham taxi owner Steve Garrado told the Herald his commercial insurance averages $7,000 to $8,000 per year per vehicle. Under the long-running taxi ordinance, the amount cabbies could charge was regulated by the city. But with that restriction eliminated by the new ordinance, one of the cab owners says he'll now have a new pricing structure with 16 variables. He'll be charging more after 11 p.m. and will continue to give discounts to loyal customers, members of the military, students, and senior citizens. So that's the.
So he's
only...
going to charge more after peak usage hours? That sounds like a terrible business model, actually.
Well, it's his business. He can do what he wants. But, you know, that's the only good news.
He can do whatever he wants because he's got a cartel monopoly over the system, is what I'm saying. It's foundationally ridiculous. You're like, okay, I'm gonna charge him more after everybody wants a service. Like, during the day, you've got to imagine there's more demand for transportation than at night, right?
It depends. If it's a party
city. Probably after last call or whatever, you probably have like a spike in demand, as the bars close or whatever. But
Portsmouth is supposedly a hip city, so there's probably stuff happening after 11.
All right, so yeah, maybe that's the case then.
Polario said his drivers all have the Uber app, so they can see where Uber drivers are located in real time. He said they'll be taking pictures and calling the police. Quote, we know who they are. If the police department doesn't enforce this, I'll go ballistic. Unquote.
Sounds like he's getting a good start on it.
The cab company owner asked Dubois if he could make a citizen's arrest. Dubois is the police chief. If he sees unregulated drivers after Thursday, and he was told no. The police chief said that in order to make a case against a driver, patrol officers have to witness the violation or receive a tip that includes a license plate number.
Oh, I would absolutely love that. Just watch these cab drivers run around kidnapping Uber drivers because they found them on an app. Just see how well that works out. That would be a really wonderful thing, really. You just see the videos coming out of that, just cabbies just kidnapping people off the streets. Be like, we got one. Look, I've got a Uber profile right here.
Dubois said then an officer has a reason to stop the vehicle. We already have the license plates, said Polario. Assistant Mayor Jim Splain said during Wednesday's meeting that, quote, we've got a good ordinance, a simple one. He says he hopes Uber, which was not represented at the meeting, will have someone review the video recording and decide to continue operating in Portsmouth if they meet those standards. But as of now, they claim Uber has not applied. And as of now, one of Uber's drivers is saying he's going to continue violating this ordinance.
Good for him.
And I think that's awesome. You can get the story about him over at freekeen.com. We'll continue here about the Peaceful Streets Project coming up.
If you own a business, you know incorporating can be a smart way to protect yourself and your assets. So the question is, why haven't you incorporated your business yet?
My business? It's too small.
Wrong. No matter how small your business, you run the risk of losing all your personal assets, your car, your home, even your entire life savings if you're not incorporated.
Incorporating is very complicated.
Actually, incorporating is easy and fast. You can do it in just 10 minutes. Call now for your free guide from incorporate.com. 1-800-945-8645.
I need a lawyer to incorporate. That's really expensive.
You don't need a lawyer, and we don't offer legal or financial advice. Incorporate.com is a service company whose only mission is helping people like you incorporate safely, easily, and quickly. Find out how simple it is to protect your family and personal assets by incorporating. Call now for your free guide. 1-800-945-8645. 1-800-945-8645. That's 1-800-945-8645.
My name is Bill Bonner, and I'm the president of the largest private news and research network in the world. And I paid for this airtime because I have an important message to the American people. There's a change coming that the government isn't telling you about. This change has deep implications for life in America, from where you shop to the doctors you visit and the family you want to protect. Look, I've made predictions like this before. Thing is, I was right then, too. A few years ago, I warned that housing prices would collapse. They did. Before that, I warned that dot-com companies would crash. They did. Those who listened had a chance to save themselves. But this has nothing to do with the stock market. This will affect us all.
You can watch the video for free right now by going to disappearingwealth.com.
Again, that's disappearingwealth.com.
Just recently, we've witnessed some of the most catastrophic disasters in history. Be sure to prepare yourself with great-tasting, high-quality, GMO-free food that has a 25-year shelf life. Of course, we're talking about the foods from SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. And don't forget, the human body needs up to 3 quarts of water every day to remain healthy and hydrated. So check out our water bricks at SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com or call 877-223-1776.
Many are in disbelief today after word of shocking allegations against a Minnesota-based talk syndication company known as GCN. It's claimed that they're the fourth largest talk syndication company in the U.S., making it even more scandalous that they've been accused of helping business owners expose themselves on a massive scale. Let's go live to Tom for more on this story.
It's being called the greatest exposure of our lifetime, while other business owners are beginning to step forward claiming they too exposed themselves with the help of GCN.
It's true. They're all guilty. Every last one of them. GCN helped me get the exposure my company needed, and just think, that was years ago. Today, GCN has like 700 affiliate stations and over 6 million downloads from iTunes and their website every month.
Imagine the exposure your company can get.
Expose your business to the masses. Email advertise at gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective. GCN.
Okay, open your mouth and say ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! This is Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll-free. 855-450-FREE is our number. That's 855-450-3733. You can still talk about the Uber crackdown, where in various different places, not just Portsmouth, New Hampshire, they are being attacked by governments and sometimes physically attacked by the cabbies themselves. I mean, I saw some video, I think it was Mexico City, where cab drivers were throwing stones at Uber drivers and like breaking windshields and things
like
that.
Looked like they had like riots in France over it at one point. These people are crazy.
It's crazy. You know, you're welcome to comment on that. Also, the toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Coming up, our very own Mark Edge is going to be in Vegas October 29th and 30th, and you can join him there with Stephanie Murphy, with Bitcoin Bell, a.k.a. Michelle Seven, Paul Pui from the Airbits wallet, Tone Vase, and Trace Meyer, and more. Stephen Michaels, you can learn more about the Bitcoin Investor Conference, the very first ever, happening at the beautiful D Hotel in Las Vegas, Nevada. The D Hotel, by the way, takes Bitcoin. So you can pay for your hotel room with Bitcoin and attend the first ever Bitcoin Investor Conference. Get your early bird tickets right now. It's an event you're not going to want to miss. Go to bitcoininvestor.com. Mark is going to be there broadcasting live. That's bitcoininvestor.com. Great opportunity to meet some of the movers and shakers in the Bitcoin industry. And it's the ground floor. It's the first ever conference. So if you're interested in this kind of stuff, this would be a good one to attend. BitcoinInvestor.com. It's October 29th and 30th in Vegas. All right. So in other news here, Christopher Cantwell, ChristopherCantwell.com, your website, you got a fresh article up there about your concern for somebody who you seem to not really care very much for, Antonio Bueller.
Yes,
you're worried about him.
I'm genuinely worried about Antonio Bueller.
Why is that? Now, who is Antonio Bueller?
Antonio Bueller is the he's the founder of the Peaceful Streets Project, and he's down in Austin, Texas. There, running around with a little crew down there, activists. They go out, they film police, that sort of thing. He was recently He's been arrested a few times in the course of this, and he's been vindicated, I think, more times than not.
Mm-hmm.
He had a recent arrest where he was putting the camera so close to the officer's face that all you could see is like the officer's like chin stubble and sweat dripping down his face, which is not an attempt to hold police accountable.
Now, a lot of the time when you record government bureaucrats, they will, or even just members of the public who are hostile, they will claim, oh, you shoved a camera in my face, even though you're 6 feet away from him.
Exactly.
You're saying he literally did have the camera in the cop's face?
Yeah, like if you want to hold police accountable, it helps to like get their entire face in the frame.
So you can
identify them. You want to see what their actions are. This was literally the guy, one of the cops was like chewing gum and Bueller had the camera like up to his lips and all you see is like the lips moving. It was obnoxious. And so they kept on telling him, stay at arm's distance, stay at arm's distance, and he wouldn't. Mm. They finally tell him, hey, all right, you're under arrest, at which point then he tries to walk away and then they charge him with resisting arrest, uh-huh. Right? They tackle him to the ground or whatever, and then he tried to hand the camera off to somebody else. They arrested his pal. Now, I don't know if that's when the shift began, but his rhetoric, if you go look at his Facebook posts, either as Antonio Bueller or on the Peaceful Streets Project Facebook page, it's been becoming increasingly violent. He's talking about whenever a cop gets shot, he's saying, good, you had it coming, that sort of thing. Now, I've said similar things, which is why I find it kind of funny, because of course when I got kicked out of cop block, part of the reason for that was a reaction from Bueller and the Peaceful Streets Project people saying that cop block was condoning violence by associating with me. Hmm. Now Antonio's coming up with this rhetoric and it looks like there's some backlash from his people there. Veterans Against Police Abuse put an article out on Photography Is Not a Crime, saying that they've funded Antonio Bueller to the tune of thousands of dollars, but they are disassociating from him. They're asking him to step down and to hand control over this thing to somebody else because of the violent rhetoric. Now, it's one thing if you've got it's one thing to be angry at the police state. That makes a lot of sense. I can even find justifications for some cheering it on when somebody gets the violence that they've been perpetrating to others, getting it paid back to them.
Sure. What goes around comes around.
What concerns me with Antonio is that Antonio is foundationally detached from reality, okay?
Why do you say that?
He's a crazy person. Look, he's talking about a world where he believes that there's a rape culture, okay? A rape culture where he says it's just like socially acceptable for a man to drag a woman behind a dumpster and have sex with her against her permission. And he's just going to go high five with all his male friends about that because that's the culture that we live in where rape is just foundationally fine.
I don't know about you, but I don't live in that world.
It's complete nonsense, right? And he will spout on about this nonsense all day long. He just feels like there's this huge oppressive system of not just the government, but just, you know, the white race oppressing all other races. Just white people are just getting together like we're gonna hang up our microphones after this and get together and be like, so how are we gonna keep the black man down today, Ian? I mean, it's just he's an absolute crazy person, and he just sees oppression and racism and sexism in everything that he does, and it really reminds me of this Vester Flanagan guy,
the killer from Virginia.
Yeah, this former reporter who got fired because he was making crazy racist allegations against his coworkers, and then he came back and gunned a couple of people down on morning television because racism. He's a total paranoid lunatic, and this is running rampant throughout the society. These social justice warrior fanatics who just think that everything is just racial and sexual oppression in every aspect of the society. And when you think that that's going on and you're talking about it's good that people are getting killed, that's dangerous.
Look, anybody who grabs a video camera and literally shoves it in a cop's face is going to get the same result.
Exactly.
I don't care who you are.
Exactly. And he's just acting like he's being arrested for being recorded. You're blocking his peripheral vision. He's on duty. He's doing things. He's responding to a disturbance. And you're creating a situation where your hand is right in his face, 2 inches away. And he knows that you're on Facebook talking about how wonderful it is that cops are getting shot in the streets. Mm-hmm. And you've got a crew of people around. And you're screaming and cursing and yelling at him just inches away from him. Of course it's going to turn out badly for you. Stop acting like you're being oppressed by some racist white supremacist system, right? It's just foundationally crazy. So when you have people who, and of course, if he's facing a situation where, you know, I think you've got some posts from John Bush down there, and yep. and Kat Blige, I've had some screenshots sent to me. I have all of these people blocked because they're all a bunch of left-wing fanatics that I want nothing
like
to do
John
with.
I like John and Kat. They're nice folks.
We'll differ opinion on that. But you know, I have all these people blocked, but people are sending me screenshots because this is a fascinating thing to watch. His friends are turning their backs on him. He's losing financial support. He's detached from reality, and he's talking about violence. Somebody needs to go talk to this guy and talk him down because it's a powder keg.
Yeah, I think you've got some legitimate concerns there, and you've got a lot of this written out over at ChristopherCantwell.com in a full article that folks can go take a look at. I've actually got the post that John Bush made, and we've had John on the show a number of times here. He's a great activist down there in Austin, and even though Chris didn't like him, I think he's a pretty great liberty activist. And I had a lot of the same concerns about Antonio's organization, the Peaceful Streets Project, years ago, because he hasn't changed in the way that Bueller hasn't changed in the way that he's approached the police over these
he's
years.
He's anything but peaceful. He's a fanatic, screaming in the streets like a maniac.
Right. I mean, he's always been awful towards the police, just, you know, yelling and name calling. And you can't have a productive conversation, and it certainly doesn't sound peaceful when you're shouting at the top of your lungs. So it seemed like a direct, you know, sort of contradiction in terms. 855-450-FREE.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow. A new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Ricky LeBlanc, admitted in Mass only, Sokolov Law, LLC, Chestnut Hill, Mass. Ken Levin, responsible attorney in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Greg Hobby, New Jersey. The choice of lawyer is an important decision that should not be based solely upon advertisements. While this firm maintains joint responsibility, most cases of this type are referred to other attorneys for principal responsibility. If you know what mesothelioma is, you or someone you love has likely been impacted by this devastating cancer. You may be entitled to compensation. Call Sokolov Law today, 1-800-218-HELP. The only known cause of mesothelioma is asbestos exposure. Thousands of hardworking men and women, including many U.S. veterans and industrial workers, have been diagnosed with mesothelioma because manufacturers knew the dangers but put profits ahead of people. An estimated $30 billion in court-ordered trusts has been set aside to pay money to asbestos victims. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma, call now. You may be entitled to receive compensation without ever going to court or filing a lawsuit. Call for a free legal consultation at 1-800-218-HELP. That's 1-800-218-HELP.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral! Don't pick on the IRS alone! I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill sometimes! I can even get it zeroed out completely!
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral!
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
Most of us already know that taking a fish oil supplement to boost omega-3s is a good idea. But did you know that about 60% of Americans are actually deficient in omega-3s? Did you know that most fish oil products contain only about 25% omega-3s and the remaining 75% is undesirable fish fat? Heck, did you know that more than 90% of fish oil supplements sold in the USA are not even made here? If you want to boost your omega-3s using the finest American-made fish oil, check out Nutrigold fish oil supplements on www.fishoil.best.
Nutrigold fish oils are independently 5-star certified and guaranteed to be exceptionally pure. That means no more fish burps. Best of all, just one Nutrigold fish oil capsule contains more omega-3s than 4 standard fish oil capsules. Go to www.fishoil.best or call 888-920-1497 and use promo code BESTFISHOIL to get a free 1-month supply. That's www.fishoil.best or call 888-920-1497.
KDArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period, with packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order. Why would you go anywhere else? KD offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KDArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free water purification kit for a limited time with any body armor package. Go to KDArmor.com. That's EATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. You can join us here. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Peaceful Streets Project. I like the name. I mean, who doesn't want peaceful streets? That sounds like a fine idea.
They even came up with a pretty good slogan, which I've used before. Protect and serve each other.
That's pretty good.
Yeah,
but
I like that.
When you actually watch the founder of the Peaceful Streets Project, Antonio Bueller, and you watch him on video doing his thing, it's anything but peaceful. Now, I can understand the anger, right? Like, I went through this phase myself where I was super angry at the police, and I don't think I was ever as loud or as obnoxious about it, but I definitely had that anger. So I can relate to it. I can understand that. I can understand wanting to see them suffer, you know, for the violence that they perpetrate, and I'm being very generic here, right?
Right.
The police perpetrate against peaceful people. I get that. But for me, it was a phase. I moved through that phase, and I was able to, when I moved to New Hampshire, here as part of the Free State Project, I'm in a place now where there's 40 cops. There are 40 uniformed cops in Keene, New Hampshire.
Right.
Now, that doesn't include the sheriffs. There's a handful of those.
Yeah,
as
stateies
well.
Out on the highways and whatnot, yeah.
But 40 cops. I mean, you're talking about dozens of people who ultimately you're going to get to know them. If you're doing cop block, which is what I do sometimes on the weekends, then you're going to encounter these guys. You're going to have conversations with them. And you can't, as long as you do this, you can't not realize that these guys are people too. They're human beings, and they should be treated like human beings. Now, we understand they're doing, in a lot of cases, the wrong thing. They're arresting young people for underage possession of alcohol, for marijuana, and for, you know, other non-crimes which don't actually involve a victim. And I can understand how it would be tempting to shout at the cops to let them know how angry you are about it. But
That sounds like awfully human treatment, actually. If we saw other people going out, I mean, we had this story before of the cabbies who wanted to go out and arrest the Uber drivers. Like, if we just saw cabbies going out and running cars off the highway and kidnapping drivers, we would rightly condemn and treat those people quite poorly. As a matter of fact, we'd probably put them in prison. Right.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, when we talk about cops, if we're going to take a position that badges don't grant extra rights, then to get extraordinarily angry with the people who are going out and snatching people off the streets and threatening lives on the highway, getting really angry at those people and treating them quite poorly does seem like we're treating them like human. I think normally we don't treat police as human. We treat them as superhuman, that they have special privileges.
Which I certainly don't want to do that. To me, they are just people. I like to call them by their first name. You know, if I know what their first name is, I will address them that way.
Yeah.
And, you know, I don't believe their badge makes them any more special than anyone else. But at the same time, I don't think you can build bridges with people if you're yelling at them and calling them names. I don't think you're going to be able to do that.
Certainly. And, you know, we've talked about before on here, and I've talked about on my show, that for all the crazy things that I've said about cops on my website, I don't think they're crazy, but, you know, for all the seemingly crazy things that I've said about police
inflammatory
on my website,
things.
Very inflammatory things on my website, some of these guys will sit down and, you know, have a conversation with me, and I actually have some pretty decent
relationships. Some of them listen to your show.
Yeah, at least one of them is a regular listener to Radical Agenda. A lot of them read the blog on a regular basis.
Yeah.
And when I talk to them and I bring up something, they're like, oh, I read the article you wrote about
right.
that, and comment intelligently about it. And
so they're proving they read it, right? Like, you know, they're exactly. saying something they wouldn't know had they not read it.
Yeah. So, you know, and when I came here, I figured that they'd get some kind of briefing and some propagandist to tell them that I'm just some evil, violent anarchist who wants to set buildings on fire. But no, they know what's going on.
Yeah, they've done their own research.
Yeah. So it is.
It's, come up with their own opinion.
It's definitely interesting to sort of have those relationships, especially in, you know, I guess part of the advantage we have here is that we're in a small town or whatever.
There's, right.
You don't have quite that with the Austin PD.
This has been one of the things I pointed out about the Austin. There's a certain segment of activists in Austin who believe that Austin is this great place where people should go to, and that, oh, we don't even need to make we don't even have to create a project. Austin's just naturally attracting all these libertarians to it. That's what I've been told, and I think it's ridiculous. But also, even if that were true, it's crazy because you've got 1,600 uniformed police in that city. And that's as of the last time I checked the numbers, which was probably a couple years ago. When I was checking those numbers, there was also a news story in publication about how the police chief in Austin, Art Acevedo, wanted to hire another 300 officers. So they had 1,600, and they may have, if he's gotten his way, 1,900 of them now at this point. That's a situation where even though you might see the same officer more than once, odds are good you probably aren't going to, especially if you're going all around the city doing various different things.
It would seem to be, from some of the videos I've seen from Antonio, he seems to know these guys' names. So, I mean, they might be working, you know, Austin's a major metropolitan area of
sorts.
Yeah,
if he's working one neighborhood, then he's probably
seen. Yeah, so you'll get to know, I mean, you know, look, you have in New York, we've got the Suffolk County Police Department, and, you know, Suffolk County is a large place, but you've got precincts, and then there are numbers of police that work within precincts, and you get to know the officers in the different stations and whatnot.
But despite getting to know them or knowing who they are, he's still super angry and maybe even angrier than ever.
Yeah, and it seems to be escalating worse by the day. As I said, you know, when I had written I wrote an article titled "Dead Men Don't Start Revolutions," where I was actually saying about the Jared and Amanda Miller shootings in Nevada, where they went and killed these cops inside of Cece's Pizza. I actually said, "Hey, this is a terrible idea, but you know, the police are not innocent victims
in
all
of this." Yeah, poor Cece's.
And yeah, and so you know, Bueller and Peaceful Streets came out with a piece, you know, attacking CopBlock for publishing my stuff, and that was a thing where I was explicitly saying, "Hey, this is a terrible idea. You shouldn't do this." Mm-hmm. Then what's happening lately is there's this, you know, this rash of cop killings that's gone on lately, and he's coming out, and every single time he's posting on the Peaceful Streets Facebook page, "Yeah, good. There's no such thing as a good cop. He had what's coming to him," and like his posts just become increasingly angry and increasingly violent and increasingly detached from reality.
Here's what John Bush had to say on a public post on his Facebook profile about 2 weeks ago about this. "For those interested, I co-founded Peaceful Streets Project, and as of late, am very concerned with the direction the group is going and the rhetoric used in representing the group. There have been many prominent activists that have distanced themselves from Antonio," that's the founder we've been discussing earlier, "recently, and there has been much bad press due to nasty and divisive rhetoric. I did my best to stand by Antonio through it all, as I consider him a friend. However, it has become increasingly clear that oftentimes the Peaceful Streets Project is a sounding board for Antonio Bueller's frustration with police. From pound F all cops to shaming anyone who feels his language is hurtful to the cause to divisive rhetoric regarding the killing of police, it is unfortunate that what had started as a noble cause has descended into anger, rage, and hate. I applaud activists within the group who focus on the filming of police rather than incessant bashing and name-calling. I implore you to work toward reform within the group, and I fear, however, that this may be impossible, as Antonio has asserted himself in a dictatorial fashion, laughing at legitimate criticism, and even going so far as to remove me from the Peaceful Streets Project Facebook page and the PSP Austin group when I rose my concerns to him and publicly. It's a bad sign for any group when, rather than address concerns publicly, the main organizer censors your posts and removes you from discussion groups. I hope Antonio finds peace and Peaceful Streets Project becomes more peaceful, as the name implies. Until then, and until others in the group join me in demanding reform, let it be known, I do not represent PSP, and PSP does not represent me. With all sincerity, John Bush, the co-founder of the Peaceful Streets Project."
So I'm going to go ahead and point out real quick. I mean, part of the problem that you've got with Antonio is this whole political correctness nonsense. And this is something that was actually started by John Bush. He bears responsibility for this screaming at people about their language and being offended at people's words that he's complaining about here. I forget the exact words he used here. But, he started with this, taking screenshots of people who said, things that he didn't like on Facebook and saying, we need to run these people out, and all this political correctness nonsense, which is putting a battery in the back of Antonio Buhler's social justice war. Your mayhem. And I think that that's a big part of the problem that you've got down there is that, they're talking about all these wonderful libertarian activists. It's a left-wing outfit. I mean, and being a left-wing agitator who's skeptical of cops does not a freedom fighter or a libertarian make.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I can understand John's concerns with the name calling. We had an issue with one of the activists here doing that a lot, and I had a conversation with him about it, and I'll tell you about that here in a moment. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live. You can share your thoughts.
Now is the time to save on hardwood and more at Lumber Liquidators' end of summer clearance sale. We're making room for new fall inventory. That means it's your chance to get an incredible deal on solid pre-finished hardwood for just 99 cents. Wide plank, hand-scraped oak for $1.99. Beautiful carbonized bamboo for $1.29. Plus, get 10 to 15% off Morningstar Bamboo, the number one selling brand of bamboo flooring. Top quality laminate and vinyl plank from 49 cents and 24-month special financing. Hurry, the end of summer clearance sale is going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Before girls' night out, my eczema flared up. Ugh, I felt like canceling. But then I tried Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. It's specially formulated for eczema and has 1% hydrocortisone, the strongest non-prescription itch medicine for fast, lasting itch relief. It quickly stopped the itch and soothed my red, dry, flaky skin. With Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief, I was ready for girls' night out, and it was the best one ever.
Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. Feel the heal. Use as directed.
A revolution in body protection has arrived only at FortressSurvivalLLC.com. Introducing the revolutionary patented Level 3 Bulletproof Vest. 100% Kevlar, 100% American made. Concealable, fully adjustable, and the lowest price on the market. Adult size normally $289.99, now just $250. Kid size normally $239.99, now just $200. Get affordable protection with a Level 3A Bulletproof Vest from FortressSurvivalLLC.com. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Psalm 31:3.
My Patriot Supply is making the choice to get prepared easier and more affordable than ever. For a limited time, a four-week emergency food supply is just $99. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-276-4010 to claim yours. Limit two per caller while supplies last. Get prepared today. Call 800-276-4010 today for your $99 four-week food emergency supply.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
My name is Dell, and I live in El Cajon, California. I was concerned about my cholesterol readings because I knew that high cholesterol is related to clogging of the arteries and increases the risk for heart attack and stroke. One day, I heard an ad for Heart and Body Extract, and I was skeptical, but I decided to give it a try. Man, the numbers don't lie.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. We've got a few moments remaining and enough time for you if you join us right now at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've also got Skype. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm. With you tonight, it's Ian.
And Cantwell.
Chris Cantwell, going to be one of the keynote speakers at the upcoming Keenvention coming up here in, we're 6 weeks away.
I am looking forward to that.
It's going to be happening literally 6 weeks away. It's going to be coming up before you know it. So if you don't have your tickets yet, you can still go and grab those. We've only got 100 tickets for pre-sale, and there are plenty of available. It's a small event. This is a very intimate convention. It's the third year. And right now we're about on par, I think, with where we were last year at this time. Because you know, I can go back to my old ticket sales and look and see, you know, how many tickets did we sell up till September 18th last year compared to this year. We're about on par. So that means it's probably going to be a fairly intimate occasion. Although you never know who's going to walk in the day of. So go ahead and lock in your tickets now for $60. That gets you the entire weekend of Keenvention, or you can pay in Bitcoin at Keenvention.info. Chris, you're going to be one of the keynote speeches. But we also have the Cop Block panel and a bunch of other panels. There are actually going to be 11 panels. There'll be three keynote speeches. There'll be the opportunity to actually go out on the streets and engage in cop blocking. Because before there was the Peaceful Streets Project, there was Cop Block. And Cop Block is still the dominant activist police accountability organization in the world.
Yeah.
Before Cop Block, there was Cop Watch, but Cop Block really has taken the cake.
They really took it off. I mean, the Facebook page last I checked had over 1.5 million. I mean, it's bigger than Police One, which is the big police blog, yeah. You know.
And of course, Cop Block's founders, Pete Eyre and Adamo Freeman, have both lived here in Keene, hoping to get Adamo to come back here at some point. I know he's actually about ready to kick off a tour in the mobile accountability. Oh, what's the C stand for? I forget. MAC. He's got his new RV. It's not new. It's new to him. It's a used RV that he purchased. They're going to be traveling around the country.
Painted it black and white.
Doing Cop Block. And the LRN.FM, Free Talk Live logos are going to be up there. Free Keen. So just like old times, we're sponsoring the tour that they're going on. So I'm a huge fan of Cop Block. And I think they do great work. I don't know how many Cop Block panels there are every year, but we're going to have one at Keenvention, and JP is going to be heading it up. He is probably the most active cop blocker here in New Hampshire. He's really, I think he earned hosting this panel. He's out there every single weekend, like three nights every weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday night. He's out in the college neighborhoods, and he's engaging in cop block. He's holding the police accountable, recording video of them harassing these college students, and handing out information to the college students to help them know their rights. I've been out there a number of those nights as well, assisting. And so when you're at Keenvention, not only will you get to watch the cop block panel, which will have JP and his panelists, which are actually, it's about to be announced in full, I believe, tomorrow. We'll announce all the panelists. But, you know, if you got questions about cop blocking, this is a great place to ask it. If you want to learn more about it from the people who've had the experience on the streets, these are people who have done that. And so that's part of what Keenvention is about. It's about getting the activists, not the fancy big name people from all around the country or around the globe, not paying to have them fly in and then put them up in a hotel room and give them thousands of dollars to come speak. Nope. Everybody at Keenvention gets their choice of a $20 gas stipend or a VIP meal. So it's a very, very low cost event to get into, which is why it's only $60 for the entire weekend at Keenvention. But also you get the chance to go out and do cop blocking. So on Friday and Saturday nights, JP will come to the hotel, 9 p.m. He'll be meeting with anybody who wants to go out and maybe you've never cop blocked before. It's a great opportunity to go out and do it because in Keene, you don't have to worry about recording. Generally, you don't have to worry about recording the Keene police. Now, our friend James Cleveland, who's an activist in the area, did get arrested for recording the state police in a certain circumstance where there was like a suicide attempt. And
That was more a thing. He's being told to move from a particular area. It's not that he's arrested for recording per se. He's arrested for what we got here, and it's sort of a silly catch-all is the disobeying a police officer is a
disorderly
problem.
Conduct.
Well, yeah. I think they actually have a specific statute of disobeying.
There is one, yeah.
And so, you know, I think every state has a disorderly conduct, which can sort of be used as a catch-all. But disorderly conduct has sort of been litigated to some extent that you've got to be creating a significant disruption or something to that effect. A situation in New Hampshire is that if a cop tells you to do something, like you literally just have to do what the cops tell you to do here, which is different than some other places.
If it's a legal order.
Well, and, yeah, he can't tell you to, you know, rape your mother, but right. He can tell you to move.
But in this case, it was a situation where James was recording as member of the media in a situation that involved a man who was threatening to suicide himself. The police had cordoned off an area, and their claim was that James was within that cordoned area. James says he was not, and that he did move back when he was first asked to move back. But then they came back and asked him to move again, and he decided to stand his ground. So he was arrested at that point. And he went to a bench trial for that, was found guilty, is now appealing to a jury trial. And that jury trial is actually happening in less than a month. That's happening in October.
That'd be interesting to see.
So, yeah, we've got a big month coming up for trials here in the Keene area. And so my general point, though, was if you want to go out and do cop blocking, Keene, New Hampshire is probably one of the best places to do it because your odds are not going to be harassed in any way by the police for recording video of them. Don't physically stick a camera in their
face. Yeah, if you don't shove a camera down his throat like Antonio Bueller or one of these lunatics, you'll probably be okay. I mean, can they go out and do some Robin Hooding while they're here, Ian?
Thanks for bringing that up. Yes, you can do some Robin Hooding. In fact, we do have plans.
That's when we like put the coin in the meter before the meter may write the ticket.
That's exactly what that is. And Robin Hooding has made international headlines. It's been a huge news story all around the world over the last couple of years. And during the last couple Keeneventions, they have basically canceled parking enforcement for the day on Friday and Saturday. And rumor has it they're going to be canceling again this year. And so I suspect that the Robin Hooding will be unsuccessful because of that. They'll go downtown hoping to Robin Hood, and then they won't be able to.
I wouldn't call it unsuccessful. I would call it success in advance.
It's super successful,
right?
Yeah.
It's to a point, ladies and gentlemen, where we just shut down government agencies.
Yeah. It's going to be great. You're going to be able to park for free in downtown Keene because the parking enforcers will be out.
People try to attack us for the Robin Hooding thing. Like, what's the point? Well, here it is. You know, right. we just actually shut down this government agency, at least for the day. They're just like, oh man, these guys are gonna be for this weekend,
right.
and they're just like, you know what, let's just not even
screw
bother
it. Yeah, we're staying in, we'll do paperwork or whatever. So that happened, and we're expecting it will happen again. Rumor has it will happen again, but maybe they're spreading that rumor because they want to fool us into thinking they're not going to be out there. Although I suspect they're not going to be out there. So the only way we'll know for sure is if people actually go out and try to Robin Hood and they just can't find the enforcers.
Well, I mean, we've got the radios and the text message system. If somebody sees a parking enforcer during Keenevention, there's going to be a report of it, I'm certain.
And
That'll definitely be on.
Well, you know, it's a great example, I think, of what can happen when you just get a relatively small concentration of people together in one area. Keenevention isn't a pork fest. You know, at pork fest, there's 1,300 people that attend. Keenevention, maybe 100 to 130 people are going to be attending. And, you know, if you can get a few dozen people in one area, the government just calls it a day. That's it. We're done. No more parking enforcement.
Yeah, they can't put up with that much. They need such a high rate of compliance. It's ridiculous. Once people are just like, I've had it with you, they're just like, oh, all right, never mind. I guess we'll just go inside and chat by the water cooler until the coffers run out.
It's absolutely true. Numbers mean everything. And so you can taste what it's like to have that, you know, that that ability to have the numbers on your side, when you start to outnumber the government bureaucrats. And in my opinion, that's where the real tipping point is here, Chris Cantwell, because we don't have it yet. We don't have enough people here yet. We've got enough people to do some really great activism, to make international headlines, you know, to be brought into court by these governments who are really upset about what we're doing. Like, we're definitely having an impact with a relatively small number of people that are here in New Hampshire.
Yeah, no question.
There's maybe a few dozen people in the Keene area at this point. That's it. Once we can outnumber the bureaucrats, so let's say there's 300 bureaucrats in this area.
Yeah.
Once the Liberty community is 500 strong in Keene, New Hampshire, it's over for them. They can't do anything. Once upon a time, there was a restaurant that kicked us out from having social Sundays at their restaurant.
Right.
And the owner of the restaurant wrote her misinformed letter to the editor about why she did that. She didn't want us proselytizing to her customers. That doesn't happen at social Sundays. We just go hang out with each other. That's it.
Right.
But so she didn't understand that. And the reason why she didn't understand that was because she was actually, I think she was the girlfriend of a Keene Fire Department person. Well, I heard from one of her employees the real story. And the real story as to why she made the move that she did was because the bureaucrats threatened to stop going and having lunch at her place, which is right downtown Keene.
Right.
So all the bureaucrats, you know, they leave during lunch hour from the city hall. They go out to the various different downtown businesses. They threatened to hurt her economically. So once we've got enough people to where we have a larger economic impact than the government bureaucrats, I think that's going to majorly tip the scales.
Be a big deal, no question about it.
Keenevention.info. You can go there to learn more. Get your tickets right now. And don't forget to go and check out more of Chris Cantwell at ChristopherCantwell.com. He's going to be the Saturday night keynote speech at Keenevention this year. Or Free Talk Live tomorrow night, freetalklive.com.
If worst comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing a...